20, it's the Adelaide Crows at home at Football Park, desperately trying to stay in touch with the final six. The Crows must win, but this afternoon they face up to the league leaders, the West Coast Eagles, who've only been beaten twice in the entire season. The Crows and the West Coast Eagles before a sell-out crowd at Football Park.
Yes, a very good afternoon, everyone, from Football Park in Adelaide. Big match, big crowd, tremendous atmosphere as round 20 continues. The West Coast Eagles and the Adelaide Crows, a vital game, certainly for the Crows, who must win every remaining encounter to stay in touch with the top bracket. This is just one of two games being played today. The other one is at the Melbourne Cricket Ground, which I dare say is just as windy here as it is at Football Park. That's between Fitzroy and Richmond, and we'll be keeping you up to date with progress scores of that encounter during the course of the afternoon. And viewers in Melbourne and Perth will be taking a replay immediately following the conclusion of this game here at Football Park. Last night at Carrara, we had the game between the Brisbane Bears and Collingwood. It saw a runaway win to the Magpies, 26-16, 172, defeating the Bears 10-11-71, and Peter Dacos finishing up with a magical 13 goals. The ladder, as it stands now, the top six, West Coast, Geelong and Hawthorn now equal on points and also on match ratio, followed by Essendon, North Melbourne and St Kilda. St Kilda yesterday or this week having the bye. And then as we move down to Adelaide, we see, as I mentioned, they must win every match to stay in touch with the five. The West Coast Eagles, of course, very, very keen to make amends, if not Don Scott in drag, after their shock loss to North Melbourne last week. And as I mentioned, the crowd here this afternoon being entertained at the moment by the respective mascots, and they're really enjoying it. One wonders if they're going to be just as cheerful at the end of the match here this afternoon. But as I said, a near sellout crowd, and I think it's going to be a great game. Well, of course, the man that's got the West Coast Eagles to where they are at the moment is Michael Malthouse. He's done tremendous things with the club since he took over the coaching role. And David Christensen looks at the man at the top.
To Malthouse, who's been one of Richmond's best three players.
The 1980 VFL Grand Final was one of Mick Malthouse's finest moments as a player. The rugged defender was among the Tigers' best as Richmond collected their 10th premiership. The Tigers haven't won one since, and neither has Mick Malthouse, although he has gone close, coaching Footscray to third place in 1985.
The top two teams to go at it now at Subiaco Oval. First bounce.
Now he's on track to go all the way again. The Eagles under Mick Malthouse are an AFL sensation. So just what is it that makes Mick Malthouse a good coach?
Well, I've never really said I'm a good coach. I think that one thing that you must have is a passion for the sport. Or not even so much for the sport, but passion for the contest. And when I see two athletes locked together in combat, I get a charge. And if you can just help them 1% overcome their opponent, and the rest is done by the player, then you've achieved your goal.
Malthouse, the coach, enjoys success, but won't let himself get too close to his players. It's a self-imposed barrier he sees as essential.
You can't afford to get too close to players or administrators, because there's always going to be a professional decision to be made, and more often than not, it's a very tough one, leaving a player out, crossing a player from the list. And if you back away from those decisions, then you're likely to make a wrong decision, I believe, anyway, given a tight situation on a match day.
Malthouse's coaching philosophy is best summed up in a new book penned by former Eagles skipper Steve Malaxis. It's to mould a side with no chinks, no stars, but plenty of options among players who are all on the same wavelength.
That's utopia. That's, to me, is the formula for success, because then you haven't got any people sort of standing aside saying, well, I achieved this and you blokes let us down. It's more, we achieved it, or it's share the pain and share the glory.
And they've certainly shared some glory in season 1991. The challenge for Mick Malthouse is to maintain the momentum.
One of the things that keeps me going is the fear of failure. And as far as a coach goes, I guess you've got to also know the game, and I've been involved now for 20 years, so I suppose I know a little bit about it. And the last thing I want to be the best coach, but I want to be the coach of the best side.
David Christensen taking a look at Michael Malthouse. At the moment, the AFL's most successful coach. He's got them at the top. And when they last met, the scores turned out like this in round 5. The West Coast quite convincingly at Subiaco over the Crows, 19-16, 130 to 9-11-65. Dennis Cometti and Don Scott joining me in the commentary box this afternoon, and Max Stevens will be bringing us up to date with what's happening on the boundary and also in the respective rooms. And Dennis and Don will be back after the break to look at today's teams.
And of course, we must introduce to the All-Port Toyota Goan Flying Squad over on the eastern side of the ground of the SAFM Rock and Roll Lady.
And welcome back to Football Park. Great atmosphere, almost a sellout crowd, a tinge of state football this one, the Eagles against the Crows. And you can see that crowd building all the time. Don Scott is with me. Don, what about the two sides? Let's check them out, beginning with the backs for the Adelaide Crows. And Nigel Smart is a man with a big job this afternoon as the Crows arrive onto Football Park. What a game it is for them. They can't afford to drop this one. Their season very much on the line this afternoon. Their record is 9-9, and one of their best victories of the season came last week, down by 19 points at halftime to Essendon. They came storming back and won by 27. Smart, a big job on Sumich, as I mentioned. Peter Sumich, 77 goals so far this season.
Maynard, the running halfback on Jakovic, who went into the ruck. I don't think McDermott will line up on halfback, but then again, they never do.
This is where the game could be won and lost, I think, across the centre. Jarman and Turley, outstanding duel.
Clute coming into the side, replacing McIntyre, who's gone out. Wiedemann will come on to interchange for Adelaide.
Up forward for Adelaide, Scott Hodges found some form. That was on a half-forward flank, though, against Essendon.
And Irving coming back into the side, his first game for a number of weeks. Mickens has been in form. And an interesting lineup with Hocking coming in. Whether Hocking will start, he usually comes off interchange.
And Wiedemann is the change for Adelaide on the bench. Quality on the bench for the West Coast Eagles, Waterman and Wilson. So the stage is set. The West Coast Eagles with the best record in the AFL. Their record is 15-2. They lost 9 days ago against North Melbourne under lights at the MCG by 3 points. Twice this season, they've lost by that margin. We're ready to go. Adelaide against the West Coast Eagles, back right after this.
Looking at the West Coast Eagles lineup for starting the budget, let's have a look at the field. As we plug out the emissions, number 16, Mark Hepburn. 27, Stephen Jackson comes out, along with 36, David Hart. So for the record, plug out 16, Mark Hepburn. 27, Stephen Jackson, and at number 36, David Hart. The interchange players for the Eagles, number 13, Scott Brothers. And number 39 is Chris Waterman. The West Coast, captained by John Worsfold and coached by Michael Malhouse. And we must say congratulations to the Craig Turner in his 50th game here at Football Park today. For the Adelaide Crows, take out number 15, David Pittman. 23, Peter McIntyre. And 45, Paul Rouvray. Into the Adelaide Crows side today, number 50, Wayne Wiedemann. The interchange players, Adelaide, 31, Stephen Rowe, and 50, Wayne Wiedemann. Adelaide is captained by Chris McDermott and coached by Graham Corns. So the opposing captains, John Worsfold for the West Coast Eagles and Chris McDermott for the Adelaide Crows, about to join the umpires, Darren Goldstein and Grant Gilman, and then finish here for Fox Elections. And crossing the coin today, ladies and gentlemen, is your 24th and former Australian Test wicketkeeper, Rodney Marsh.
Into the breeze.
Back at Football Park, we've just seen the toss of the coin. John Worsfold has won it. Let's go down to Max Stevens for news from Mitsubishi.
Thanks very much, Dennis. And conditions here pretty good for football, but there's a strong wind. Our current temperature is 18.6 degrees and our expected high 18 degrees, so we've passed that already. The wind, a strong northwesterly of about 10 k's, maybe getting up to about 15. The goal advantage would suggest 3-4 at this point of time. Now it's blowing right down the middle of the ground, left to right of screen. The ground condition, well, it's excellent. Humidity 50% and the forecast fine and mild, cloudy at times, which it is right now.
Thanks, Max. So the Eagles, surprisingly, have decided to go into the breeze, Don Scott.
Amazing. It is surprising because it is quite a strong breeze, Dennis. But then again, I suppose maybe the effectiveness of the wind will be limited by the fact that the ground is ringed by stands.
nonetheless, if they put a high ball up towards the lake end, it will definitely hold up.
What about a selection, Pete?
Up here, Dennis, you'd have to go for the Crows, wouldn't you?
Don't be intimidated.
Form says the Eagles, doesn't it, really? But I think it's going to be a pretty good game. As you mentioned, it's got a tinge of interstate rivalry here.
And it looks like Barrich and Jakovic going on to interchange for the West Coast. Wiedemann and Rowe for the Crows.
Jakovic, that's a surprise too.
Also Barrich, because he's kicked goals in the last few weeks in the forward pocket for the West Coast. Then again, Turley started on the bench last week.
A couple of surprises by the Eagles before the match has got underway.
Listen to that roar. The Adelaide Crows, their season on the line, and the West Coast Eagles.
Just interesting down in the forward pocket for the Crows. Wren stuck out his hand to Lockyer. Lockyer ignored it.
Goal spink and Vernon, the umpires. Underway. Pike obviously tagging McGuinness in the foreground there. And the rucks go at it. Micken wins it down. McDermott claimed immediately. Pike's over the ball, going nowhere. Fragenza. This is Klug. High kick inside the attacking 50. It goes a long way on the breeze. McKenna almost. Jamison. Hart. Hurried hands. Wren stood his ground well. Lockyer came over the top. Klug back in the action. Brennan. Back towards halfback. Drifting towards the boundary. Fragenza. Hard against that boundary. Back over his head. McGuinness takes it across.
Already a bit of feeling, because as soon as the ball was bounced, the West Coast captain John Worsfold and Scott Hodges were on it, into it.
And that breeze really is about 20 or 30 knots, I reckon. Wren up high, very tall. McDermott, centering kick to the goal square, over the top, no one home. Lockyer does the shepherding for McKenna. And the Eagles get clear, he'll go for the boundary line. Doesn't really get there. Filkey, main wearing. McKenna again. Takes the ball with him, almost held but not in possession. The umpire says play on. Brennan. Short kick. Again, standing right up into the breeze. This really is a gale. Wobbles. Now the Crows, if they're to get anywhere, really have to make the most of this first quarter. Great mark by Matera. And Matera at centre field. Low trajectory kick, understandable in view of the conditions.
There's a mark to start! Mark of the day already! Great grab!
Kicks out the centre wing, Fragenza. And Fragenza marks. Long kicks needed by the Crows. And that's a beautiful drop putt. Up towards right half forward. Klug again.
He's off.
Centering kick. McKenna goes back, almost the mark. Couldn't control it. Wren battling with Pike. Watch this.
What a mark. Wings of a Crow.
So a bounce about 30 metres out from Adelaide's attacking goal. Hodges down to Jamison. Lockyer stood his ground. Courageous mark. Jamison was bearing down.
There's 50.
So Lockyer, aided by the 50, comes up to midfield. A real buzz of expectation around this ground. The league leaders have come to town, and they'll get a battle this afternoon. Towards centre wing, Matera, good mark in front, not paid. That was tough. Matera did well. It's out of bounds and will be thrown in. Look, the mark gone.
Was, I would have paid it actually, Dennis. Thought he was also interfered with by Tregenza, so he could have got the free kick.
Langdon in front, Micken from behind. Turley's got the run of it now on centre wing. Having a wonderful season, Craig Turley. Probing kick inside 50, Sumich in front. McIntosh gets the crumbs. Mainwaring out towards right half forward in trouble. Gets away from Smart. Down towards full forward. Wilson. Clever mark.
Be a handy goal, Dennis.
Yes, under the breeze, certainly. So Peter Wilson, about 25 metres out, very slight angle. Important kick. And he's missed.
I think again indicative of the force of this breeze, he was kicking right into it. So the first score coming up, taking us just on 4 minutes, and that perhaps is surprising. Adelaide really have to make something this quarter. Wallace missed it. Gets taken high. Umpire calls play on. The ball spills free out at the edge of the square. Tregenza taps it further forward. Chance for Brennan. This way, that way. And finally a high left footer. And a good mark is dragged down by Pike. Pike at the left half-back flank. Lead is on towards centre wing. A marking contest. None taken. Thompson gets ridden into the ground. Over the top, Langdon. Ball rebounds. Slapped out towards the boundary line again. That was good play. And out of bounds mark taken by Pike again. So two possessions to Pike. Gets himself into trouble. Tried to just be a little bit too smart. McDermott. Tregenza. Centering kick from him. Waterman overruns it. Chance for Hart. His opposite number three is Mainwaring. And look at that ball standing right up into the breeze. Oh, Micken taken high. Nothing for it. Crowd didn't like that. Irving, good hand pass. Kip on the end of it. Bounces okay for Turley, and the Eagles swing into attack.
Turley inside the attacking 50. Simic goes back. Smart fisting away. Thompson's got the run of it. Nice ball. Bilkey to Smart. He's up on centre wing. He likes a run. Long kick. It goes about 65 metres and bounces out of bounds at left half forward.
The coach trying to make a change. They're trying to get Wiedemann onto the ground, but they just can't work it at the moment.
There he is. Wayne Wiedemann.
Via Fish Creek, Collingwood, Canberra and West Torrens.
Doesn't everybody. Turley in trouble. It's out of bounds. Another throw-in. Tough day for football, given the nature of this breeze. Wren and Irving. Irving winning it forward. Pike kicking around the outer side. McIntosh in front out there, but Micken comes back and takes a very good mark. Gutsy mark, aided by the breeze. He read it best. He goes in short. Pays. This is Thompson. Long kick down towards the kickoff line. McKenna goes back. Jamison couldn't control it. McKenna once more confronted by Hocking this time. And a bounce.
So a chance for Adelaide's first score. The defence of the Eagles so far has stood up well. Led by number 17 there, Guy McKenna. 15 metres out. It's going to be Wren, number 52. One of the rookies in the Crows side. He's done well so far. Waters. Gets clear, but only just. A wild hand pass after a pretty good tackle. Tregenza. Micken Langdon! Good hip and shoulder bump. Great stuff. Brennan. Micken again. Clue. Not a great kick. Oh, Irving. Nearly spilled his lollies there. Defensively to the outer side. Kilkey has got the speed to get around Turley. Only just. Hart. Outside 50. But he could kick this.
Thompson off for the Crows. Wiedemann going onto the half back line, picking up Wilson.
Looks as though he's going to try the drop punt. He's gone short. The lead is on. Mark taken by Jamison. But the angle is not good.
He's a much improved player, Rodney Jamison. He led really well last week against Essendon too. The hole should not have occurred. The ruckman should have been dropping into that hole.
But Don, I'd ask you the wisdom of leading to the pocket. With a strong breeze like this, it's pretty close to the boundary line, isn't he?
Well, he is, but then again, Hart was a fair way out. He would have had trouble making that distance with the wind behind him.
So for the Crows, first score. He's not going to score. It's out of bounds, and out of bounds on the full. So that's a wasted kick. It's going to be taken by Irving, who's been on the sidelines recently with injury, from left back pocket. Irving kicks to halfback, marking contest. Micken fists the ball forward. Turley, well tackled, feeds out the hand pass. Matera drops it, chance for McGuinness. He's grabbed, but not in position, nothing for it. But it infringed, the umpire says okay. Tregenza feeds out the hand pass over the top. Pike is there.
Pike in the centre square. Did well. Long kick down towards half forward. Wilson in front. Wiedemann from behind fisting away. Wilson cleverly into the path of Main Waring, who's outnumbered 3-1. Out of bounds would be fine here. Hayes does it for him. I think the Eagles happy with that result. Andrew Payers, number 24. Micken and McIntosh. Micken, nicely. Jarman, well done. Towards centre wing. Klug, what a valuable player he is. Look at my big mouth. Here's Filkey. He started well, Filkey. Centering kick. McDermott running towards half forward. Jamison comes on the lead. McDermott goes for distance. Off target, minus score.
Interesting to note that Maynard was right down beside McDermott. Maynard loves to run off half back. And he also created their option for Filkey.
So one behind each. But remember, Adelaide going with a pretty strong breeze. Oh, marking contest. They went every which way there. Nobody came down with the ball. And the Eagles threw Pike again. Well, McKenna it was. The centre wing. Langdon. Not too popular. And the ball over the boundary line in front of Lee for a throw-in. A throw-in next to the interchange area. Both sides registering one behind. 15 and a quarter minutes left in the opening term. Micken. Wiedemann. Jarman decides to go for a run. Wiedemann does the shepherding. Keeps Lamb at bay and does well. Centering kick beautifully delivered. Jamison. I'd like to see him have a shot from there, Don.
Well, he's got the wind behind. This is where Hart had the ball earlier. He could probably get the distance.
Well, look at that. He's got the distance. It's a goal. Great kick.
Well, he is a magnificent kick of the ball, Rodney Jamison. He is really improving, coming to grips with the game. A little at sea earlier in the season, but it's a good pass there by Jarman on the 50-metre line, so he lets it go from about 55 metres out. Remember, there's a strong breeze.
Went through post high.
It was a magnificent kick. His first and the Crows' first.
That first goal coming after 10 minutes of play, though, so the Eagles would be content at the moment, I think. This is Lamb alongside the centre circle towards half forward. Wiedemann and centre half back. Very high kick towards the outer side, half forward flank. Going back, Main Waring. Gutsy mark and not easy on this wind. Main Waring's kick towards Turley. Bounces out of bounds. So a throw in, outer side. Greg Turley. His 50th game today in the AFL. Throw in, McIntosh and Micken. Langdon from behind. Lee in trouble. Wiedemann confronted by Langdon, bounced off him. Hocking couldn't control it. They're going in solidly. Wilson over the ball, that's holding it. No.
Barrett's warming up, doing his stretches on the side. The West Coast about to make a change.
Haven't the umpires relented on holding the ball?
Mid-season, it would appear.
Yes, round by round. McIntosh, Wilson again in trouble. Hocking leads in the race, left it behind though. This is Filkey. Filkey from half back towards midfield. Klug battling with Brennan. Waiting behind tackle. McGuinness, strong tackle, brought him down. The tackler was Pike. Matera comes away, kicks towards half forward. Maynard in the road.
Maynard kicks to centre wing. Crows lose everywhere. Klug, he's been a very damaging player. That's almost a hospital hand pass, that job. Lee. Long kick, no one at home. Mark dropped. Snapshot by Wren was smothered. Didn't get very far at all. That's out of bounds on the full, and could have been kicking in danger anyway, couldn't it? Well, Tregenza, not wasting any time, kicks from outside 50. And that's through for one behind. You can really see the wind once that ball got above the height of the stand. It was never going to make it through the goals. Big crowd. Enjoying a tight contest so far, 12 and a half minutes left in the term.
And that breeze really is picking up now. Favouring the end that the West Coast are kicking to.
The Crows.
Oh, the Crows.
So I think they'll need a few more on the board. Jamieson got nudged out of it. Bilkey. Ball into the pocket. Oh, Wren. Great mark. Not paying. Great Wren like that. Matera. Just gets his kick in. Micken. Too slow. Waters. Taken high. And that's what the umpire has paid. The arms were up too high initially. And the umpire right on the spot to pay that free kick to Scott Waters, who kicks to centre wing. And that could be a mark to Turley. The umpire says no. Kept in play. Now it comes to Kemp from Matera.
Ooh, the pressure's on.
It certainly is. Kick partially smothered. And the kick by Hart comes up towards half forward.
Knocked away by Worsfold, taken by Brennan. Mainwaring. Back in defence to help out. Kemp, great mark, full stretch. Plays on immediately. Waterman looking for Wilson. Wiedemann going back on him. Smart, mishandled. Wilson goes off the ground. Vacant goal square, doesn't matter much. It's going towards the pocket. Wiedemann and Wilson out of bounds. So the Eagles doing pretty well. This breeze very strong. And at the present time, they trail by just 7 points. No spare man in defence either. They're playing their own game at the moment. Maynard to Hart. Around the outer side with a kick. Clude comes to meet it. Mainwaring gets it superbly. Chris Mainwaring running out of space, out of bounds. Throw in. Not too many empty seats today. Interesting, they won last week against Essendon. Great victory, and immediately after the game, their focus was squarely on this one. Brennan, Mainwaring, towards half-forward Langdon, away he goes. Probing kick, out comes Sumic, drops the mark, should have held it. Wiedemann in trouble.
Tasker, taking the hand pass from Pays, loose ball in the back pocket. This is Tregenza. Tregenza's kick is out of bounds now. And for a few seconds it looked as though it was going to be out of bounds on the full.
This is a fantastic game. The contests around the ground, the pressure. Even in the kicks, a lot of kicks going astray.
Langdon at the back. Lee, a quick kick up towards the edge of the square. Kemp, Matera from a standing start. Kicks into the left forward pocket. Heady the target. Tasker. Over the top is equal to the task.
Brennan coming off. Brennan coming off. The West Coast, McIntosh on.
Wearing number 53, which is interesting because they only have 52 players on their list. Micken taps down. Turley, snapshot. Oh, he might have thrown it down. It's a goal. Great kick. And that was just what the Crows did not want. 1-2
to 1-1. Well, he's probably one of their most consistent, if not their most consistent player this year, Craig Turley. Micken up. Good tackle once again. That was Barrage. Not much reaction, although there is quite a strong following here from the West Coast. From Perth.
Adelaide by a solitary point now. Clock continues to run. This is Jarman out of the middle on the breeze. It goes about 70 metres. Up in front, McKenna couldn't control it. McGuinness, 25 metres out, sprays it wide. It's out of bounds on the full in the left full forward pocket. The Crows need to hoist the spinnaker at the present time. On the breeze, need some goals. They need them quickly. Don Pike out of defence. High towards half back. McIntosh goes back. Irving trying to knock it through the pack. Filkey was taken high, I fancy. He's got the free kick. Bradley Filkey wasting no time. Down towards full forward. Wren under the ball. Knocked away by Lockyer. Boundary throw in. Interesting football park. Very similar to Subiaco Oval. It's 3 metres shorter. 11 metres wider. Wren. Irving just being playful. Jamieson lost it. Pike goes off the ground.
Yeah, on the full.
On the full in the left full forward pocket. Interesting shot, this one for Filkey. He'll need to pop it up about towards the kickoff line and hope the Breeze grabs it and pulls it left to right as we're watching. Too early. Minor score.
I think the feeling would be that the Crows haven't got enough on the board so far. They lead by 2 points, but just over 8 minutes remaining in the term. Looking at the flags again, you would reckon on perhaps a five-goal quarter. Lockyer marks the kickoff. Good shepherd by Turley. And kicks long, or as long as he can. Punch away by Wiedemann. At the back is Barrich. Lee. Ball kicked out to Maynard. Jarman.
Oh, good handball.
And they're going to get out of this. Thompson kicks up towards Micken. Wiedemann, a little bit too long. Oh, no, he gets taken out of it. Mainwaring. And they're making good use of the ball, the Eagles. This is McIntosh. Kicks towards half forward. Turley again, who's been their only goal kicker. Langdon gives it back to him. He'll kick into the pocket. Where's Sumich? Could have taken the mark. Punched away from him. Maynard goes almost for the boundary line. Pays, Jarman. Pays, or Langdon. Jarman. And finally they're going to get clear. Carl Langdon throwing his body in with great advantage.
Surely. He pushed McIntyre out before he went for that ball.
And he got away with it, Don. And the umpire says play on, and the Crows do. The ball kicked up towards full forward. No mark paid. Into the forward pocket. And the chance down there for Rowe, but the ball was beaten everybody out of bounds. It's going to be a throw at about 25 metres from the scoring area. Under 7 minutes left in the term.
Stephen Rowe on the ground in place of Wren. Looking to force a mismatch in that Eagles defence, Graham Corns. Not a bad idea late in the term. Initially Lockyer had him, but they've sorted that out. Worsfold has now gone on to Rowe. Meantime, Irving's getting a free kick to Pike. Nothing doing this side of the ground. Matera and Tregenza, this will be interesting. One out, two very skillful players. Tregenza wins the day. The Crows could force the Eagles into trouble here. Tregenza from the pocket, centering kick. It fell behind. McIntosh keeps it in front. Good shepherding from Waterman. Hodges stood in the road. 40 metres out from goal. Oh. Sprays it. Out of bounds on the full in the right full forward pocket. Well, the Eagles took a risk coming this side. Pike made his move before he realised that there was nothing on. Lockyer in the back pocket.
5 minutes 47 left in the quarter. Lockyer's kick just makes it to the 50 metre mark. Big pack of players down there. A hand pass comes out to Klug, who kicks from a standing start into the square, but Lockyer's there again, got a fingernail to it, and it's out of bounds. Throw in about 5 metres from the behind post now. The Crows defence, or the Eagles defence this quarter, has worked overtime, but importantly has worked together particularly well. It's going to be Irving and Klug. Actually, they both misread it. And snapshot is off target for a behind. So 1-4.
It's quite obvious, Peter, that the Crows are going to go long into their forward line, especially the full forward line, taking Wren off. They really haven't got a high mark unless they get Hodges down there. Because on that occasion, the ball came down. It was all small fellows.
So McIntosh to kick in. And he goes straight up the ground. For all intents and purposes anyway, Irving over the top. McDermott, there is a whistle. It's got to be a Crows free kick to be taken by Mark Micken. And of course, formerly of the Brisbane Bears. Micken puts it high, lets the wind do the rest. Hodges in a one-on-two situation down there, but it's through for only one behind. So 1-5. And really, you would have to say, Dennis, that that isn't enough.
No.
Then again, so you wouldn't discount the Crows, because the way they're putting the pressure on, just as the Eagles are doing, they can do the same, so it could be an even second quarter.
Not easy to kick goals, mark you. Micken marking the kick in. The tactic's very important here, and the Eagles not playing it too well. They're kicking directly up the ground into the teeth of the Breeze because they're playing the huddle. Adelaide posting the outriders, and the Eagles deciding, well, they've got the numbers in the middle, I'll kick it there. But both times, this man has finished up with the ball from 50 metres out. target practice and he misses again. This could cost them. Now I think the Eagles have got to break from their strategy and get people out wide on that defensive wing. No good playing the huddle if you're kicking it where the opposition wants it to go. And McKenna comes this side a little wider this time. That's better. Over the top, Maynard. Off the ground, Matera. Klug coming to meet the ball. He's a fine player. Almost held without it. Well done by McIntosh. Matera knocked on by Hetty. Tregenza across to Jarman. Down he goes. Hetty backing up Turley. Kicks down towards the 50. Wiedemann's in front.
There's Duck Wilson's coming on too, Wiedemann.
Yep. Rugged looking customer. Towards midfield, not a good kick. Mainwaring got a hand on it. Two Eagles to one Crow. Lending assistance though, Filkey. And Filkey was held without it. Well played initially by Clue. Filkey's away alongside the centre circle. Goes looking for Hodges. Should have marked it. McIntosh comes away. Nothing's easy out there. That breeze pushing the ball through very quickly. Mainwaring had the run of it, lost it. Mainwaring does well battling with McGuinness. Oh. Held without it, I thought. It's out of bounds and will be thrown in.
Well, I thought that Mainwaring should have had that free kick. You see there that McGuinness was manhandling him. He had front position.
Both going for the ball, weren't they, Don? I think both made the ball the objective.
The three umpire system.
Irving taps down to Kemp. Backing up, giving support was Wilson. He's been pretty busy up there, made the most of his opportunities. McDermott trying to charge his way through, and the end result quite successful from a Crows point of view. Jamison couldn't take the mark. A scramble, tackle. McKenna getting ridden into the ground. Hockey, Filkey, McGuinness around Waterman, but only just Hockey. Centering kick, Hodges, yes! No, not paid by the umpire. Ball kicked away by Waters. And the Eagles might get clear of this. Matera.
There's no one down further to the ground. Consequently, he had the handball on the ground, Matera.
Tregenza, crowd looking for a free kick. Kemp dives on top of the ball. Matera would have been ambitious to claim one there.
Well, I didn't think Tregenza had the ball, did he?
One, two. No.
No, he really didn't control it.
Good work by McIntosh in the end. A bounce short of right half forward for the Crows. And they all dive on it. And so it's all tied up again. A minute and a half left in this quarter. Plenty of pressure applied by both sides. Been a good quarter of football. The bottom line will be the half-time score, of course. Chance for McDermott to pick the ball up. Matera grabbed and taken down. That's a push in the back, says the umpire. Free kick for the West Coast Eagles at left half-back flank. Matera will finally get the ball back. I think perhaps hoping for 50 metres. There was none there. Hugs the boundary line. Two Crows up. Wiedemann at the back. Ball kicked away by Lee up towards midfield.
Jamison, a spring heel jack up in front. McGuinness, long kick, one out contest. Hodges dropping back. McIntosh is with him, just the two of them down there. Free goal, no. Just missed. There's the time remaining. 1-7 to 1-1. Marvellous quarter by the Eagles defence, applying great pressure. They've held firm. Waterman towards half forward. Wiedemann. Not paid, or is it?
Yes, it is.
So the test now will be for the Crows defence in the second term. They've got to match the Eagles. Long kick towards half forward. Jamison fisted away by Lockyer. Knocked on by Hart, taken by Klug. Stood up in the tackle. Well done. Micken. Jarman fumbles, uncharacteristic of him. Matera's away, there's the siren. Quarter time at Football Park. Have the Crows blown their chances in this game, and with it, perhaps for the season. 1-7, 1-1. quarter time here at Football Park. The Crows lead by 6 points. First use of the breeze, 1-7 to 1-1. Plenty of big sport coming up on 7 Sport. The Australian Touring Car Championship continues with round 9 at Oran Park. That's Sunday, August 11. And coming soon, the World Athletics Championships from Tokyo. Telecasts commence on August 24 through until September 1. We'll have highlights each night. Check your local guides for programming details. Richmond playing Fitzroy. If you don't want to know, look away. Max Stevens is on the boundary. Max, what about that wind?
Well, Dennis, the wind is definitely far stronger than what we said at the beginning of the game. I would suggest it's gusting up to about 25 k's. Now, Michael Malthouse, he believes the key in this quarter is, one, to show this parochial crowd how they can play football. He wants them to get the ball out of the centre first and go straight for home, straight down to the full forward area. Don't worry too much about Peter Sumich, because, as I said, that strong wind is really starting to gust up. Now, Graham Corns, obviously very disappointed. He claims that Adelaide got to the ball as much as the West Coast. However, they didn't use it to their advantage. He wants them to tighten up and go for broke. Otherwise, the Eagles could run away with this game.
Thanks, Max. Irving wins it down to start this second term. Tregenza, hurried kick, knocked away by Lamb. Turley has been busy. Waters. Jarman's got him. McDermott an opportunity now. Combines with Rowe. Not a good kick, but effective from the Crows' perspective. Tregenza takes the mark about 15 metres further afield. Goes out towards right half forward and Klug.
Tom Klug, one of their best players so far up forward. Klug again going short against the breeze. And McGuinness taking the mark in front of Pike. And that did quite a good job in the first quarter. Get McGuinness fairly quiet. McGuinness missing last week against Essendon here at Football Park. Marking contest. McKenna. Worsfold. Langdon waits for it, doesn't come as far as him. And the ball scooped out the back by McDermott. Matera, Langdon almost caught. Lamb from midfield. Long to full forward. Sumich at the back. Gathers in the bouncing ball, kicks and puts it through.
Well, Nigel Smart could ask, umpire, why wasn't I given a free kick? Because Sumich edged him out. Middley was on the run. He was disguised. Smart on the run. Now watch this. The ball from Lamb. It's a long one. And there by Sumich. How the umpires don't pick that up is beyond me. It's happening far too often. But anyway, they all count. And his first, Peter Sumich.
Sumich won. Turley won. The goal kickers for the West Coast Eagles. And so they draw level. And still 23 and a half minutes left in this quarter. So this is going to test the Crows out, certainly. Turley again.
Smother.
Excellent smother. Klug gets the ball out of the centre. Chance for Filkey to make something of it. Forward line is wide open if they can make something of this now. Hodges handballs to himself virtually. Not too much support. Good block by McIntosh. Waterman in trouble. Regains the ball and picks it up with a centering kick. Kicks to the centre wing position. And a good mark is taken by Mark Micken.
Plays on immediately out to the skipper McDermott. Goes looking for Jamieson.
Now that was holding, surely. No, it's against Jamieson. The umpire saying that Jamieson had the shirt or the jumper of McKenna, pulled him down. Well, wow. Six of one and a half a dozen of another.
I think you're being kind. McKenna's got it, the crowd unhappy. Well, hard to see a free kick in there for the Eagles, but they'll take it. McKenna goes short. Good vision. Here's Waters. Centre half back. Waters. Long probing kick towards half forward. Clears the pack. Turley an opportunity behind. Well played, Turley. Kept it going. Off the ground now by Wilson. It's a four on one situation. Lamb. Wilson. Goal. Oh, great stop by the West Coast Eagles. Running hard. Running in numbers. And they lead already. Just minutes into the opening of the second term, and already they're making their move.
And you see there, they're not really quick, are they, on the defence? Wiedemann, a good player, got a lot of courage, but just hasn't got the leg speed. But also you can question the free kick that happened down the other end of the ground against Jamieson on McKenna. would it have been a goal to Wilson?
Two goals this quarter and already the Eagles in front. Good work on their forward line, making the most of the breeze. Irving and Micken go at it. Hart, Hocking, Lee, short kick, still inside the square. Hodges will look for the hand pass, and well done to Tregenza.
Why did he go long? There's no one there.
No one there, Don. Klug, can he get back? Jamison taken out of it. Good hip and shoulder. That'll be a free kick to the Eagles too.
And the Crows are playing two loose men on the back line when the ball's bounced.
Waterman to Worsfold. Worsfold from the back pocket. He will look for Langdon, who marks just short of centre wing. The Eagles so far making much better use of the breeze. And their defence, of course, did well in the first quarter. Heady, he's been surprisingly quiet. McDermott to Jarman, to Filkey, back to Jarman. Longer hand pass this time. Now Tasker. And it goes to Hart. Hocking. And the Crows answer the challenge. They're lifting. Jamison taken out of it. McKenna. Scott Waters at left halfback flank. Good little player. Kemp on his own.
Heady.
Picked him out beautifully. Quiet in the first quarter. Then again, the ball didn't come down there that much. Turley in front. Almost an amazing mark. Ball slapped out the back. Sumich, can he make it two? Smart's attempted smother, not successful. It's a score. One behind only. But the Eagles' tally goes to three goals, two. 3-2 to 1-7. 20 and a half left in the half.
A couple of lessons to be learnt there. Just how composed that Eagles' defence is one, and how good Turley is another. Terrific stuff, outnumbered. And getting the ball onto Sumich. Here's Tasker. Finds Wiedemann in the back pocket. Over 20 minutes remaining till half time. Wiedemann towards half back. Micken has played very well.
Good mark.
For the first three seasons in the competition, he is the skipper of the Brisbane Bears, Mark Micken. This is Klug between half back and wing. And this is the worst possible scenario for the Crows. The Eagles making a good start to the second term. 3-2-1-7. Throw in just forward of left centre wing for the Crows. Irving and Klug. It falls to Kemp. Kicks towards half forward. Steadying mark taken by McDermott.
Play on quickly, the umpire's called it.
McDermott gives it away, Turley. Turley's hand pass finds Lamb. Little chip pass to Wilson, who falls over but marks it on his chest. And the alarm bells are starting to sound for the Crows already. Here's Wilson. He'll kick from about 60 out, and just looking at him, you get the impression he fancies his chances. He'll give it a ride, a torpedo punt, no, the drop punt. It's going, it's close, they contest about 5 metres out, and the ball trickles out of bounds alongside the behind post in the right full forward pocket.
So Boundary throw in, forward pocket for the West Coast Eagles. Micken and Jakovic. Mark taken by Mainwaring. Now he would need to aim for the left goalpost. He's done that. Trying to land the ball just off the edge of the square. Smart, his second great mark for the day. Not as spectacular as the first. McDermott to Maynard. On to Tregenza. They'll get clear this time. Lee. Butters up well. Kick smothered. Wilson, dragged down by Maynard, holding the ball, says the crowd. The umpire says no.
Good row.
McDermott. Tregenza. Jarman caught behind. Support for the West Coast from Worsfold. It's out of bounds. On centre wing.
Some good work by Matera on the half-back flank or half-forward flank for the Eagles.
Irving and Klug. Irving has the height. Klug gets front position. Out it comes to Waterman. Quick kick from a standing start. Lee has to go for the hurried hand pass. Tregenza gives it back to the skipper. McDermott kicks to half forward. Filkey relays it quickly. McGuinness, long kick inside scoring range now. But there's no one home. And Mainwaring
takes the uncontested mark. He'll kick the centre wing. Long kick with the breeze. Brett Hedy, been fairly quiet today, breaks the tackle. That was of Pays. In towards full forward. And Langdon leading out beautifully, marks just inside 50. And the West Coast on playing with a lot of confidence now.
Yes, it was a really heavy shepherd by Kemp on Pays. Just as Hedy was getting rid of the ball, maybe should have been looked at it free.
Off target, may just be a behind. No, it's not. It's out of bounds on the full. So a free kick to the Crows in the back pocket. Tasker. Tasker kicks in, and Smart, who's been very effective today. His aerial work has been supreme, and Maynard kicks to centre wing.
McIntosh, almost the mark. Made Waring to Pike. He's at right half forward, Don Pike. Gets away well from McGuinness. Kicks down towards full forward. Awkward one for the defenders. Turley favoured by the bounce. He's having a wonderful game, Craig Turley. Gets it to Jakovic. Dragged down. Well played by Lee. And it spills out of bounds in the pocket. Surprisingly, Jakovic, starting on the bench, only his eighth game of the season. A very impressive debut so far, but relegated today. Micken liked his game to row at close quarters. Wiedemann's got it now out of the back pocket towards half back. Klug trying very hard, knocked away by Lockyer. Pike comes to it, it's out of bounds. The Eagles by 7 points, just under 16 minutes remaining till half time. This game being played under partly cloudy skies and a very strong breeze. Packed house. Jakovic gets it down. McDermott across to Hart. Klug coming again, always presenting himself, takes the mark in front. From the ground, plays on to Rowe. Left half back towards centre wing. Wasted kick. McIntosh.
McIntosh on centre wing. And centres the kick. Away goes Waterman. No one chasing him. Waterman, Langdon on a lead. Well, comes out. Nearly took the mark from behind. Maynard. Dragged to the ground. Ball spills free again. Langdon. Jakovic. Loose ball. Lee. Does well at right half back. Still he goes. Needs support. Not going to get it. Warsaw. Does the tidying up work. Pike, who's been a very good player, especially in a tight first quarter, relays it to Kemp, whose disposal is usually impeccable. Sumich and Hart. Hart wins out this duel, farms away the hand pass of Bradley Filkey. And that's a well, badly directed kick. Kemp covering plenty of territory. Waters, the on-boarders of the Eagles, are doing well. Smart. McGuinness. Too fast for Jakovic. Look for support, finally gets it in Tasker. Defence working overtime, Pays. Wiedemann, I like Wiedemann's style. Rowe up in front, didn't take the mark, was well spoiled. Mainwaring, real finals pressure here. On to Don Pike, centering kick from him. The target will be Simic, he's nowhere down there though at the moment. And Micken, who's done particularly well today, takes the mark. On to McDermott, on to Maynard, defence of the Crows now. Matching that of the Eagles in the first quarter. This is Pays. On a Hart. Kick smothered beautifully by Kemp. Off the ground by Hart. Still it's an Eagles ball. This time Waters.
Wiedemann favoured by the kick. Waiting behind Lee. To Micken. They're soaking up a fair degree of pressure, Adelaide. Towards centre wing. Brennan out of mid-air. And it goes out of bounds. Some great pressure applied by the Eagles forwards. And so far the Crows meeting it. Still a long way to go in the second term. A goal for the Crows into the breeze would be very handy. Only two men forward of centre for them now. Scramble on centre wing. Filkey at the base of all of that. Rose in there too. Ball up.
McDermott playing as a loose man. Now Micken's going back to assist. So they've got loose men in the back line, the Crows.
Bounce on the wing. Irving. Filkey. Smothered. Pike, hurried kick down towards right half forward. Maynard comes across. Bounces out of bounds right next to the 50. Carl Langdon. In the foreground, Craig Turley. Micken and Jakovic. Micken has been terrific so far. McDermott collecting plenty of possessions. Hayes hard against the boundary line, yeah. Nowhere to go. And it will be thrown in. Tasker and Turley. Tasker and Turley. What happening there? And it's going to be Tasker's free.
Pretty soft free kick.
He's got it. He'll take it. High one. In front, Hodges. Waters, quick hands, main wearing, he settles, he likes his chances from here. That's a magnificent kick. Well, he measured that one. His eyes were bulging as he took that hand pass. He liked what he saw up ahead, and it was a great goal. 4-2, 1-7, Langdon comes off the ground.
And here it is, the build-up, Waters. There was no one in the goal square. He lets fly. That's the only option he had. He could have dragged it back into the centre, but he was on the run, 45 metres out. The angle a little acute, but it didn't present a problem to Chris Mainwaring. His first.
4-2 plays 1-7. 12 minutes left in the half. Hart, Kemp, Wilson. High kick will just make the edge of the square, and Filkey takes a well-judged mark. Well, they've got to get one or two in reply to stay and touch the Crows. Klug, they're breaking down at half forward against this wind. Short kick.
Play on quickly, Hart.
We can't. Kemp stands the mark pretty quickly. McKenna leads out and marks and gets coat hanged. Now, that could be 50.
What about Jamieson behind play?
Waterman, left half-back flank. Marking contest on centre wing, Jakovic is there, throws it out of bounds deliberately. Well, you would think deliberately. So we await the boundary throw-in. Jakovic and Maynard. Maynard wins it. Crows ball. Short to Brennan. Good mark. One-handed. Mark. Plays on quickly. Trying to take advantage over the head of Tasker. Wiedemann, Tasker again, Smart, very stylish player for the Crows, and that's a good kick against the breeze, up towards the 50 metre line. Lamb, quick hand pass to Pipe, he gets offloaded as he kicked, nothing downfield though. The marking contest, none there, and that's out of bounds on the floor against Sumic. A little bit of bad luck for the full forward. He can't believe his bad luck. The Crows will certainly take advantage of it now. This is McDermott, the skipper, at half-back. Need a couple of quick replies, as I said before. Lee from Hart. Jamieson couldn't take the mark. Scooped up by McKenna. That surely would have been close to a throw. Umpire says no. Turley, who has done well, gets it back to McKenna, and again, the Eagles are clear.
McKenna has been terrific. Ball was out of bounds. 4-2-1-7. 9:35 till half time. The Crows can ill afford to concede any more scores here. Tough contract for them. Wiedemann in reverse. Down he went, and the umpire comes across to ball it up.
Good head out by Micken. Down we throw in.
He's played very well, hasn't he? Always puts in Mark Micken. His form this season as good as at any time in the AFL. Wilson over the top, Kemp in trouble, held a long time in the tackle. Tasker, now Wilson, up and under, floating down towards the 50. Maynard went back with courage, comes to Pays, kicks towards centre wing. The Eagles in number. There's five Eagles around this situation. Brennan plays on, not a good kick. Matera in front, good mark. Gee, that was a good mark. Brennan's kick wasn't well timed. Very awkward one to mark on the breeze, and Matera in front. One grab if you don't mind.
It's quite evident by that action of Brennan that they've got to get the ball. They're trying to get the ball down there quickly and doing it in a long manner. As long as they just get it on, it wasn't a good kick off the boot by Brennan. Still found its mark.
The lead is 13 points. This could stretch it to 19. Peter Matera, goal-kicking wingman. Distance won't be a problem. It's close. I think it's home. It is.
Well, Peter Matera, one of the improved players in this West Coast side, really has had a good year. Probably down last week, beaten, probably for the first time against North Melbourne. But then again, a lot of his teammates were also beaten in that game. And that is a very, very good kick for goal.
Wearing Sumich, Turley, Wilson and now Matera, the goal kickers for the West Coast Eagles, all singles. Micken taps down. Now can the Crows make something of this? Filkey. Jamieson, nearly. Hand pass comes out to Waterman and turn on to Waters. He gets around Hockey. Plenty of options open for him. Brings it to the grandstand side and finds Lamb. The mark's in front of Jarman. McKenna. Over the top, Mainwaring. Mainwaring short of right half forward. And McDermott, yes, he'll pay the mark. Skipper leading from the front as he does always. 7.25 minutes left before half time.
Young backwards.
Badly need a goal. Smart on his own, and the ball bounces nicely for him, and he's going to have a bounce. Filkey running with him. And he kicks the centre wing on the outer side. Worsfold was in front, didn't come out with the ball. Tregenza's kick is close to the boundary line. Just landed inside, I fancy, in front of Waterman. And it's going to be a boundary throw-in. Lux of fortune.
Not too many of the Crows players have got genuine leg speed, but one that does is Tregenza.
He's been one of their best players today too, Don. Klug, he's done well. There's Tregenza again. Past Waterman. Not a good kick. Hodges. Or McIntosh into his back. No. And Hodges has a few home truths for the umpire.
Well, the interpretation this season is different, isn't it, on that rule? If the player is trying to get at the ball.
Yes, if the ball's the objective.
Yes, it's not the right interpretation, I don't think.
Rowe. Dispossessed quickly. Waters. And to Waterman. He kicks to Kemp, who takes the mark just inside the boundary line on the outer side.
Dean Kemp, the 117th man taken back in the 89 draft. The blue chipper. There's Micken again. Plays on. Tregenza. Interesting duel at Tregenza and Matera. Kemp, cover mark. So far, I think Matera shading Tregenza on the outer side. Kemp down towards half forward with a kick. Micken pushed in the back.
And he will get the free kick.
Plays on now from half back. Down towards half forward. Klug knocked away by Brennan. Hart. McDermott's got the run of it now. He's at right half forward. Chris McDermott. Good looking kick down towards Hodges. Knocked away by McIntosh. Through the legs of Lamb. Said it again. There's McIntosh. Towards the other side wing. Matera's got it. Away goes the speedster. Unloads for a long bomb, not a good kick. Sprays off the side of the boot. How will it bounce? Smart knocks it straight to his rival Sumich. Did well to smother off the boot. In goes Barrich, wrestling for the ball with Smart. Drawn up. Terrific start from all players there.
A good effort in the end by Smart.
Eagles 5-2, Crows 1-7. Just under 5 minutes remaining till half time.
The bounce inside the Eagles scoring zone. Jarman up to midfield. Klug, strong grab,
playing well.
Tregenza, one of their best. Pardon me, he and Micken. This time Hodges. He's got his hands to the ball a lot today, but they just don't stick. McKenna goes down. Waters applies the tackle. Ball out to Kemp. It spills free again. Good tackle applied by Hodges. Tregenza, Jarman from a standing start. Hart, yes, but outside 50. Or is he off?
Yes, he is. Play on.
And Klug in front of Worsfold has taken the mark, but right on the boundary.
He's come back very well, hasn't he? They're only forward so far in this game.
He's gone in short again. And McKenna chips in. Gets a hand to it. End result of which it hit the behind posts, and so it will be out of bounds. Throw in
in the Crows right forward pocket. No score from them this quarter. Brennan. Not what we call a clean possession. Rowe applies the tackle, scooped out the back to Hart, who puts the ball high. It'll land in front of the square. They need a mark. Mainwaring, good speed. He'll track the ball to the boundary line. Didn't go out for him.
Well, that's
well, kicked in play. He got it out the hocking, and now it is out of bounds. And so another throw in to take place, this time about 35 metres out from the goals.
Robbie Thompson limbering up.
Can they get a score before half-time? The clock ticks down, 3 minutes remaining. Knocked down by Hodges. Mainwaring, Klug pinches it. Great effort, snapshot. Jamison. Play on.
That's ball.
Matera. And he will do the tidying up work.
Grandstand side with a kick.
Oh,
superb mark. Well, the umpire, in fairness, was calling touch ball all the way from Klug's boot to Jamison.
Good effort by Matera to get back in the back pocket. He's playing on the wing.
Collective sigh around the ground when Jamison decided to catch it and play on. He had no alternative. Micken, one of his rare mistakes, but made amends. McDermott gets it away. Tasker over the top. Here's Hart. The Crows coming back strongly in the last 5 minutes, having a good patch. Down towards Hodges. Still he goes, Hodges. 40 metres out. Bacon Goldsgrove bounces one through. Great solo effort. He wrestled with McIntosh. He won the day. No easy kick, but he got the goal. 5-2, 2-7. What a valuable goal that was.
Well, he had to do it all here. And he's a good player, McIntosh. One of the finds of the year. He's very strong, deceptively quick, and he's got a very, very good lead. And a good effort by Hodges.
2-7 to 5-2. Knocked down by Micken, who's having a great game. Klug, Mainwaring. The Eagles are going to get clear again. Out towards the centre wing position, and Craig Turley. This man's been brilliant this afternoon. Plenty of options for him down there. Wilson made the lead. Good backup support from Heddy, who's been surprisingly quiet. Could kick a goal here. He won't. Smart. Brilliant. Gets Smart, but they won't. He's chipped in. Can they make something of this now? Long kick by Smart off the edge of the square. 2-on-1 in favour of the Eagles. Good mark taken by Matera.
Djokovic off. Langdon onto the West Coast.
Brilliant effort by Smart down there. And what he has done today really has been right out of the box. Need a few more of him. Turley grab. Lamb. High kick. Wiedemann. We'll see it roll through for one behind. The West Coast 5-3. Now their score to 2-7. Am I a bit ahead of the scoreboard? No, 5-3 is correct. 5-3 to 2-7. We've got a minute left.
Sean Tasker. A very important minute, this one. I can't let the Eagles in for a goal here. Tasker, grandstand side. Micken. Oh, terrific.
Playing well, isn't he?
Oh, great game.
Towards the wing. Hart. He's been very busy in this turn. Can centre it to Maynard. They're looking better now. Filkey. Can the Crows get a late goal? Down towards half forward. Free running ball. Knocked away by Hodges. Quick hands Jarman. Jamison back to Hodges. 45 metres out. It holds up in the breeze. Worsfold all the time in the world. To Brennan, and the Eagles run it out. We're down to 22 seconds now remaining. Here's Langdon. Time enough for one more goal for either side. The Eagles have the ball at the present time. Sumich, long kick. Back goes Heddy. Tasker, good mark. Plays on. Back towards the wing. Mainwaring over the top, didn't touch the ball.
Free kick. That's shipping. That's shipping.
Advantage is paid. Waters runs on. We're down to the siren. No further score. So half time, and listen to that crowd. Wow, I'm happy. 5-3 to 2-7 at Football Park.
This is Junior Hart, Tom Brack, ladies and gentlemen. We have pleasure in presenting the 100 Jack Super League game for you between the Adelaide Crows and the West Coast Eagles. All these players, of course, represent respective high schools in South Australia, and they certainly enjoy their football, and no doubt they'll be very, very close to playing the football here this afternoon.
Uptown at Football Park, and the West Coast Eagles lead by 14 after they trailed by 6 at quarter time. Goal scorers for the Eagles, Mainwaring, Sumich, Turley, Wilson and Matera, and for Adelaide, Hodges and Jamison. Well, Don, 1-7. In this sort of situation, often will get you into trouble. It could come back to haunt them, couldn't it?
Well, it could, Dennis. I think the wind is the factor here. And really, footballers don't like, one thing that footballers don't like playing in, it is the windy conditions today. And they forecast the wind will get stronger. And, you know, it's favouring the end at Adelaide on a kick within this, the third quarter. But I was really impressed with the way that the Eagles, I'm getting mixed up with my birds here. The way they got back in defence, they used the ball well, and they've got real leg speed in comparison to the Crows. The Crows have got to move the ball quicker. They do it with handball. They try and get on. Actually, there you can see that vindicated with the handballs, 91 to 50, but they just haven't got the real leg speed to get across the ground.
Mark Meckin has been terrific as far as the Crows are concerned, but they've got the job in front of them. Of course, last week they trailed by 19 points at halftime against the Bombers and came back to win it. Well, I've got to say, I'm glad the players of June are over. Look, no gloves. Here are the players of July.
What was that all about? Just a little short one.
Oh, Schultz tried to pull the towel away.
And he... All right, the Swans gathering for the last quarter. Kappa gathering his gear. Thank you very much. Spalding. He goes for the bounce.
West Coast charging away as goal umpire Barrich gives the all clear.
Well, close to the boundary line. A couple of those Collingwood players certainly went hard at the ball.
Ralph Smith back with a fight went into his teammate Harvey.
Kicks it into that far side. Oh, what a mark! Dale Lewis.
Another opportunity. Simpson's long kick. Kick it!
Oh, what a mark!
What a mark!
Actually, I was wondering when I was going to get a look in. Now I know how the Crows hierarchy felt at VFL Park. Mind you, I don't think I would have done that to the coach's box window. Yes, James, what you're holding is called a football. And the idea is to kick it. Oh, James, I said kick it. Perhaps, James, you could take a lesson from Sydney's Jason Love, because after all, he kicked one of July's great goals. Last month saw Carlton coach David Parkin embark on his new youth policy, obviously with the year 2000 in mind. Could this be the league's first 700-gamer? And the Gardenia Park cat has been hard at it in recent weeks. Admittedly, he did cop a left jab down at Moorabbin. But what about the backhand reply? No, my friend, you are guilty and must be punished. I wonder if we'll be seeing you next month.
These things happen. So the players of July, right there. August got off to a good start yesterday, of course. Alan Jakovich, Peter Dacos. So some highlights already in the can as far as August is concerned. The 9-9 Adelaide Crows, their season on the line. Half-time here at Football Park. Can they get back? We'll find out surely. Coming up shortly, we'll have news on the match between Fitzroy and Richmond at the Melbourne Cricket Ground.
Adam O'Neill from Jordan, who reports to the match office, please. Adam O'Neill.
Half-time at Football Park and the West Coast Eagles leading here over the Crows by 14 points. It's 5-3 to 2-7. Well, two of the cellar dwellers in the AFL, Richmond and Fitzroy, are playing this afternoon at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Here are some highlights from that game.
From Hogg and now Mitchell. Now, he's just the wrong bloke to give a paddock to, and he's away with a second bounce. He can go all the way here, Mitchell, and kick a goal. Three bounces, goes from 50 metres, kicks it very, very well. And a good effort by Lynch there to get his fingers on it. Well, was it a goal? I don't believe it. Half-forward line. Rather Harding tries a half volley. Good handle by Baldwin. Osborne normally a good kick. And he's kicked that superbly for a goal. Scott with him. Smith, well played. Could have used a handball, decided not to. Goes for a bounce. He'll handball now. Draws the player, goes over the top, and Gale kicks the goal. But the mark taken by Baldwin quickly plays on to Bunn, who hasn't got a lot to kick to and does it very poorly and sets up the opportunity for Turner to bang it back over the head.
Player O'Connell just a few metres further afield, still a chance. Osborne 50 metres from goal, round onto the right foot goes Richard Osborne and kicks it long and kicks it beautifully.
Well, I guess you've got to say that pride is very much on the line at the Melbourne Cricket Ground today. Those two sides playing for just that. Now, we've got a replay coming up later. If you don't wish to know the score, look away now. Those replays will be seen in Melbourne and Perth following our game from Football Park. The second half in prospect, it should be a beauty. The Crows and the Eagles, that right after this.
After a very high caliber game with Hungry Jack Littleway, let's show our appreciation to the boys for a fantastic game of football out there today.
Park. The Crows are out there. Halftime scoreline, the Eagles 5-3, the Crows 2-7.
Max Stephens, any success in breaking security with the Eagles?
Yes, we did, in fact, Dennis. Michael Malthouse, in fact, invited us into the rooms, and for about the first 5 to 10 minutes, the Eagles spent that time doing warm-up exercises while Mickey Malthouse was handing out instructions. He's made it very clear that the game starts again now in this second half, and we've really got to man up. Man up is the key word that he wants his players to perform in this third term. Now, he's told the forwards in particular to watch Nigel Smart and Rodney Maynard. He feels that when the ball got to the ground that they continually ran away with the ball, so he wants those guys watched like a hawk, or an eagle in fact. Now, Graham Corns, he wants a third quarter burst, very similar to that performance against Essendon last weekend. He says they're still in touch, and he's a firm believer that if Adelaide really concentrates, they can win this game. They must play man-on-man football due to the wind conditions here. Keep attacking, don't worry about the flanks, use that centre corridor and go for broke, kick it straight to the goals.
Well done, Max, that's got to be a first. One of Michael Malthouse's favourites, obviously. Max getting in the rooms down there and part of the halftime activities with the West Coast Eagles. Just a reminder, the Yardley Gold Footballer of the Year will be announced at a gala evening at the Sydney Convention Centre on August 21st. Past winners were Rugby League champion Michael O'Connor in 1988 and AFL stars Tim Watson in 89 and Paul Salmon in 90. This year's nominations include AFL stars Stuart Lowe, Simon Madden, David Bain, Dennis Carroll, Paul Ruse and Chris Lewis. Paul O'Conn from the National Soccer League, also a nominee. Rugby League champs Alan Langer, Mal Meninga, Andrew Ettinghausen and Brett Kenny, along with Rugby Union's Simon Poitevin and Tim Horan, just to name a few. Some great names there. And you can register your vote for the Yardley Gold Footballer of the Year by filling in the entry forms in these publications or obtaining an entry from your Yardley pharmacist. Half-time at Football Park and the Eagles making their way out now. Well, what do you think, Don? Can they get back from here, these Crows?
Well, I wouldn't deny the Crows. After their last effort against Essendon, it was fantastic in the third quarter. But this wind is a real problem, and the Eagles will probably get down and do what the Crows did, is block up that back line and try and hold the game up and quickly go through individual stats.
Very impressive at centre half forward, 20 possessions. John Klug, for a side that's kicked only two goals. So the start of the third term at Football Park, and you get the feeling Adelaide's season riding on this quarter. They need goals, they need plenty of them. Wren goes up and wins it down, sharked by Turley, who kicks it straight up in the air. Langdon missed it. McDermott tackled front on by Turley, and the ball up.
And Lockyer on the bench too for the West Coast.
Obviously Michael Malthouse saw a matchup he didn't like out in the ground, because initially Lockyer came down to the interchange gates. We'll watch that. One down by Wren again. Mainwaring goes back. Good evasion through the traffic. Goes long towards half forward. Barrich stayed upright. Lost the ball off the ground by Heddy. It struck Tasker, which was just as well because Wilson was on in the middle, unattended. So a throw in. You get the feeling a goal into the breeze to start this term could just about break their resistance. Langdon in front, Wren, his third ruck knock, the second of which have gone to Turley. Across it comes from Turley, and the mark is taken by Lamb. I'd say too far out to score into this breeze. He'll kick from about 45. Lamb's kick, they'll contest a couple of metres out. Smart from behind, forces are behind.
Well, they've got a score on the board early in the first quarter. The first part of the third quarter, the Eagles. And of course, only one score came to the Crows in the previous quarter. That was a goal. Took them a long time to get it to. Tasker. Stuttering run up. Oh, look where he's kicked that, almost to the centre of the ground.
Turley,
yes. Should be paid the mark.
Might be a bit of a luxury having Micken down on the forward line. They do need him up the ground.
Well, the Eagles through Barrich and towards Smart. 25-metre hand pass. They might still come unstuck. Tregenza has it well smothered by Wilson.
who wins the ball. Well done. A throw. Out of bounds deliberately or whatever. Very lucky. Blind side of the umpire. Peter Wilson escapes unscathed. Wren, high, taps down, pays. Wren again, takes the hand pass. Long kick by Tasker. Gets it up towards right half forward. Oh, Hodges taken high, surely. Too far out to score, though, even with this breeze. He's a right half forward flank. Goes for the torpedo punt kick. Gets onto it almost, and almost a mark to Nicken. Holding the ball.
It's obviously the plan of the Crows, because they've got Nicken there for the high mark and Jamison for the lead. They're both starting in the goal square, or they did on that occasion.
McIntosh. Langdon in front. Maynard over the top. Good mark.
Doesn't mind running down the ground, this fellow.
Yes, he's come down to kick a few goals. Maynard, 55 out. Breeze behind him. Puts it high. It'll go close. Oh, magnificent kick for a goal! Just what they wanted. Adelaide getting the first goal in the second half. Maynard gets his first.
Well, if you listen to the instructions at half-time by Mick Malthouse, the players had to watch this fellow and also Smart. And that is a tremendous kick, 60 metres out, and it went over the goal line. Rodney Maynard, the centre half-back.
Well, that could be a team lifter. 9 points the difference. We're back in the middle. Wren and Irving. Good bounce from the umpire too. Umpire goals pink. It's one down by Irving. Out of midair by Lamb.
He's hurt himself too, Irving.
Yes, he's down as Lee and Kilkey combine to send the ball forward. This is Waterman. Short to Turley. This will be a test for the Eagles now. The crowd willing these Crows on. Main Wearing to Kemp. So far this season, of course, they've met just about every challenge. The West Coast Eagles. Smart goes back, deep in his own defensive area, drops it over the top. Tasker comes away, kicks to the outer side. McDermott, clever mark, no support. Well, he found some. It was a long hand pass. McGuinness has been quiet to Maynard again, running from half back. Penetrating kick down towards Micken. Pack into the air, Micken behind. Hurried kick, Worsfold. Wants to play on and does, across the goal face. McIntosh needs to keep his head and didn't.
Good harassment.
Well,
Hodges.
Worsfold was there. Or was it Brennan who was going to do the shepherding? I think it was Brennan. But eventually, however, they didn't do too well. Thrown in. Offhands knocked on by Waters. Hodges. Trying to force the issue there, pops it out of bounds on the full, in the right full forward pocket. 5-4 West Coast, 3-7 Adelaide. Ashley McIntosh, having a fine rookie season, out of the back pocket, towards half back. Micken comes back, strong mark in from the side, Wren. So the youngster thrilling this crowd to start the third term.
He's gone.
Leaders on. Victor. Not taken by Rowe. Now,
Rowe acknowledging Wren.
Can he kick it, Don?
Well, he's got the breeze behind him, Peter. That's to his advantage. He'll let it go from about 45 metres.
Should get the distance. He's got the distance. I don't know about the accuracy. Only one behind, so a bad miss. If the Crows can get the next goal, they will really start to believe in themselves. But perhaps they could go on to take this out. 26-34. The Eagles, of course, will have to win in the final quarter. A knock on. Opens it up for Turley at the back. He gets taken down by Wren and will get the free kick. Craig Turley from left halfback flank.
It's good to see the big fella prepared to chase the little fellow. He had Turley then. He gave away the free kick, but the endeavour was there.
Well, he stopped the run too. Pike, who had a very good first quarter. Dropping short into the blaze, and that's a great mark taken by Pays.
Mothian going to come on for the Eagles.
Wren and Irving. Irving seems to have recovered from that knock he got. I think it was in the knee. McDermott goes down, taken high. McGuinness The two super mats of the Crows combining. It kicks to half forward. Jarman punches, tried to get it to Rowe. Brennan overruns it. Waters. A quick kick along the ground. McGuinness again. Hand pass. Filkey. Onto that left foot. Tregent to the target. Got a fingernail to it, and that was all Klug. Kicks to space at half forward. Jamison. Worsfold. Worsfold from left half back flank. And the Eagles will run the ball out again. This is Waterman. Langdon was the target. Maynard beats him to it. Tasker from McDermott. Now they've got loose players everywhere. They could really go on with this. This is Lee. Jamison in the pocket. Not too much support there, so it goes backwards and does well to find Jarman.
Well played.
Good use of the body, the ball.
Jarman from 55 metres. Misses to the near side.
This is what they did, Dennis, in the first quarter when they registered 1-7.
Yep. But they're playing a bit more like they did in the third term last week against Essendon. Starting to run the ball now. Getting numbers around the ball.
And they're prepared to put their body in, Dennis.
They're not gone yet. McIntosh. Virtually being denied the outer side of the ground by those men very deep. Wren was up. Irving lost it. Hodges goes over the top. McDermott, 50 metres out, a question of accuracy, and this one has got it. McDermott gets his first goal, the fourth for the Crows. And now we've got ourselves a game.
And here it is, Wren coming over the top contesting. Could have pulled it down, the ball will spill out. McDermott, good handball by Hodges, quickly gets his kick. And they're only 1 point behind.
Jakovic warming up on the boundary line, but back into the centre. It's only 1 point the difference now. The crowd really coming to life, and the Crows go forward again. Worsfold doing battle. Can't pick it up. Tries to farm out a hand pass. Successful eventually. Mainwaring. Waterman drag. Ball spills free. Filkey applying the tackle, and he did it well. Crows again. Can't stop Turley. Onto Mainwaring. Into the Eagles' forward pocket. Lockyer dragged off it. Umpire says no. I think he must have been impressed by the Academy Award performance.
Irving going off, and Jakovic is going to go obviously into the ruck. He did that last week, Glenn Jakovic.
I wonder if Irving's 100% fit, Don. We saw him in a little bit of bother before. Wren taps down, out the back. Langdon. Well, good kick. Out in front of goals for Sumic. Smart's done a good job on him. Sumic ducking back quickly. Sockers the ball into goal. And tucks through. Excellent effort by Sumic. Tried to match the effort perhaps yesterday at the MCG of Alan Jakovic. Who kicked a real scissors-type soccer goal. One of his 11. Tasker will kick the ball in. 16 and a half minutes left in the third term.
Wiedemann over the top for Genza.
Excuse me, please.
Must be a real late free kick.
Why isn't it reportable then?
Here's Smart, forward of half back. Long down towards half forward. Worsfold up in front. Langdon in trouble. There's Lamb between the lines. In short, Matera, almost a clever mark. Tregenza did well. Lamb again, right on the boundary line. Down towards the attacking 50. Wren. She's impressive.
My word, he is. He's got a bit of life in the legs.
Only 18. This is Lee towards midfield. McDermott. He's been industrious too in this term. Hart smothered superbly by Wilson. Still Wilson held with honour. Nothing doing. There's going to be a ball.
Can't the umpire see that he was right in the position then to pay that free kick to Wilson?
Well, he didn't.
Oh, everyone else could.
Perhaps we should all get a whistle.
Oh.
That'd help. So a bounce down towards centre-half forward. Langdon, big leap. Back goes Lee. Not a good kick. Mainwaring has to wait for it. In from the side, McDermott did well. Filkey now, one bounce through midfield. Looking for Jamison. Oh, I thought he was interfered with.
No, I'd pay that to McKenna.
Over the top, the hand pass, McKenna. Worsfold back to McKenna. Certainly a lot of contact there as they approach that ball. This is Lamb. Down he goes. Lockyer keeps it in. No, it's out. Out earlier. So we've got a throw in. Well, the crowd are fuming. They thought Jamison should have got the free. It was marginal. Were they shoulder to shoulder, or was McKenna maybe that half stride behind? Hard to tell. Throw in, left half forward. Petty smothered off the boot by McGuinness. Pike got it out. Kemp tries to keep it going. Well played by Maynard. Lee couldn't control it. This is McGuinness. Still he goes, McGuinness. Well played.
Tony McGuinness missed out last week.
It was not a relay free kick.
Kicks to centre field. Klug. The opportunity for the hand pass. Not a good one to Filkey. Clear of Mainwaring. He kicks into space at left half forward. Hodges over the top. Needs support, but there's none there. And Mainwaring does the easiest piece of tidying up work that he'll get all day and finds Peter Wilson. It's a good mark. Low down Turley. Well, the Eagles at the moment have the answers.
You sound like a gunslinger.
Smart and Sumich. That'll be out of bounds or a free kick and might be against Sumich. Yes, it is. In the back. So pays to take the free. So Pose from left half-back flank, kicks to centre wing. No one can take the mark. Oh,
Filkey got one.
Taken high, and there will be a free kick. It'll be taken by Grantley Filkey. Max Stevens has some news for us.
Dean Irving, Peter, has a worry with his right knee. It's the same knee that's been giving him trouble during the past few weeks.
Thank you, Max. Yes, we thought as much. And Jamison, yes! And within kicking distance, he's a beautiful kick. They kicked their first goal this afternoon from a similar spot. Here it is again. Greg Lee, knee in the back of
Jakovic.
Glenn Jakovic. Then we said Allen.
Just watching that too. He might have touched that, you know, in front. It looked a bit that way,
didn't
it?
Could have been. Anyway, he's got the ball. That's what counts. Rod Jamison, kick number six. He's got onto it. But accuracy just a little astray and only one behind. So a point to the Crows. Crowd looking for a goal. They didn't get one. 4-10 to 5-5. Will it be a match, Dennis, of missed opportunities?
Could well be. A few of the Eagles wanting to argue that ball was touched. Jakovic wasn't one of them. He was taking inventory of the stop marks on his back. McIntosh, member's side. Jakovic goes up again. Wren. Couldn't control it. Brennan did well. Matera's away. It's been an outstanding duel, Matera and Tregenza. This is Lamb. Has to wait a long time. Well played. Ooh, Kemp. Back to goal. Has the poise to go around and find Lockyer. Andrew Lockyer, normally a very good kick. This is no exception. Into the teeth of that cross. Oh. Almost the mark. Not paid. Tasker knocks it Adelaide's way. Well done. Wiedemann. Liked his game. Gets it to McDermott, generalling things through midfield at the present time, Chris McDermott. Tregenza goes down towards half forward. The Eagles have got the numbers. Towering mark taken by Jakovic. Got plenty of time, the Eagles. They lead by a point.
In change direction.
12 minutes remaining till three-quarter time, so I guess you've got to say they're about 13 minutes in front at the present time, the Eagles. Still have the balance of power. McDermott goes across the field. Filkey. Alongside the centre circle, Filkey, long kick, Jakovic in from the side, it falls behind, Brennan's got it, Mainwaring is breaking for him on the outer side, now Mainwaring can take it and go, Mainwaring, can he keep it in, yes he can, he kicks towards centre wing, awkward kick, it runs out of bounds, not easy though, coming up into the breeze, as you turn and run back into the breeze, the ball as you drop it to kick, fully exposed to the wind, and the job is getting it down in control.
Onto the boot. Wren in front of Lockyer, but it's won by Lockyer. Pays to half forward. Oh! Jamison, nearly a screamer. McKenna nearly caught with it to Jakovic. Waters, there's the long and the short of it. And Waters out to centre wing. And Kemp, whose work is generally tidy. 11 minutes left in the quarter. Kemp, right centre wing. Big pack of players down there. Wren got two hands to it. Craig Turley has speed at the back. We'll go close to a score. Oh, gee, hit the post and the goal umpire. Well done, sir. One behind. The triple play. Post of the goal umpire on the point. Tasker. Straight down the ground. Magnificent kick again with the breeze. Jankovic couldn't take the mark. Tregenza runs off it. Klug. McGuinness. 25-metre hand pass. Now it comes back to Tregenza. Another hand pass. This time to Jarman. Turns around. Kicks. And goes.
Now that's a better effort because what they're doing, they're predictable. They're trying to kick the long bomb the whole time, the Crows, and even the Eagles fall into that trap, hoping that someone will take the big mark. But if you can run it down like you do normally, don't get out of your pattern of play. Just play normal football. They did it that time. They ran it down with a series of handballs. And then Jarman finished it off. That was great play around the outer wing.
The Crows lead by 4 points then. There's the time remaining in this term. Not sure Jarman wanted the ball. I think he was telling Tregenza to take a shot. He finished up with it. And such was the poise of the champ. He simply turned around and banged it through. Pike in the grasp. Brennan does well. Lost it then though. Lamb, Kemp in trouble. Hart at close quarters. McGuinness. The Crows go forward again. Jarman is down there. Clever mark behind. Well, the 87 McGarry medal is putting on a clinic in that area at the present time. To McDermott, long bomb goal.
Well, that's the second. Again, coming in a similar fashion, a handball. If they keep that style of play instead of kicking long bombs, admittedly that came from 50 metres out, McDermott second. He kicked one earlier from the, on the opposite side of the ground. But here's Jarman playing on quickly. Now that's the way to run it on. With the aid of the breeze, McDermott put through his second.
So McDermott, the first player today to kick two goals. 9.5 minutes left in this quarter. Jankovic hacks it out of the air. He's been watching his brother, Maynard and Langdon. Here they come again. Long kick by Tregenza to half forward. Almost clears the pack. Still there to be one close to the boundary line, and Worsfold nearly went for it. And now it's over. Jankovic picks it up, but there will be a boundary throw-in about 75 to 80 metres away from the Crows' goal. 9 minutes left. Can they get another couple of goals that have really opened this game right up, with the Eagles having the wind in the last quarter? Jankovic taps down. McGuinness did well to get a kick in. Tregenza doesn't bounce too kindly for him. In fact, I'll be putting it mildly.
Scott Hodges doesn't look too good, Peter, near where the ball's going to be thrown in. He's limping, hands on hips.
That would certainly be a blow, wouldn't it, Don? Skipper's hand pass. Is it effective? Jarman takes it. Quick. Hodges gets taken down again. Would have almost got a free kick. Scooped out of the pack. Mainwaring off the ground. Lamb. He'll get it back again. Mainwaring at left centre wing. Covering plenty of territory. Look for Langdon. Too fast for him. And Maynard will successfully see the ball over the boundary line. We'll throw in inside 50, the Eagles in attack at their left half forward flank.
Terrific game this one now. Very gutsy combination. The Adelaide Crows kept on coming. I suppose nothing to lose, their season riding on this result. Turley robbed of the ball, Wiedemann picked his pocket. To Pays, to Tasker, advantages Pay, fight on behind play, and some hefty blows were struck too. Meantime, Smart gives it to Filkey. Jamison, carried forward, will get the free kick.
Emergency umpires running out for Maynard and Langdon. That's behind play, whether he makes a report.
Hasn't got the book out, but must have missed it early. A couple of range finders. Meantime, Jamison's got the ball. He's kicked one goal. Generally, McKenna has been the master in that duel. Jamison from 55. This place will erupt if he kicks a goal. He has. His second. And the Crows are moving away now. There's 7-10 and the West Coast Eagles are 5-6.
Well, he's the leading goal kicker as far as the Eagles go. Subic cutting off. We haven't seen that before, and Heady coming on, So Mick Malthouse not frightened by reputation. It's going to be an interesting match. Heady going on to Smart.
And in a sensation, Peter Sumich taken from the ground. 7-10, plays 5-6 as a desperate measures for the Eagles. Malthouse not afraid to make moves. Rowe gets taken down. And there's even dust out there in the middle. Something we haven't got in Melbourne at the moment. Turley hands the ball back to the umpire. The Eagles, of course, having the breeze. It's more than a breeze, as we've mentioned on quite a few occasions today. Like a gale. Waters finally fisted clear. The ball doesn't bounce too tightly. Wiedemann or Langan cops one.
Wow.
And 50 metres, thank you. Costly. You would suggest it would result in a goal. Too high for Wiedemann. Right on the goal square.
50 metres point, Peter, that's the point. 50 metres, okay, the free kick in the centre of the ground, but have a look at this. This is costly.
Well, you can't
just
do that, Don.
You just can't afford to do it, Peter, can you?
So Carl Langdon,
especially on the forward line or forward at the centre.
Against the wind, this is a gift goal for the Eagles. An indiscretion proving costly to the extent of one goal. Kicked by Carl Langdon, he's got the last line.
Yes, you work so hard with the breeze, and they have done that, the Crows, but then they give away this stupid free kick. That wasn't the 50 metres. This was the 50 metres, the play that went on after that infringement. I don't think Wiedemann will back off, Carl.
Well, Langdon, a pretty experienced campaigner, and he got the goal. 10 points the difference still in favour of the Adelaide Crows. They've got 6.5 minutes left with the win. Can they get a couple more? That did not help their cause. Let's get back to the footy. Tap down by Red. Out it goes to Matera. Couldn't handle it. There is a whistle.
Holding the man. Matera's back in the centre.
Peter Matera to take the free kick at left centre wing. Probably close to the middle of the ground when he finally took the ball. Up in front was McIntosh. At the back is Red. He'll look for a hand pass. No, chips it short. He's found his skipper, and he won't lose any votes for that.
He's been terrific in this quarter. Chris McDermott plays on. Long towards half forward, Worsfold. Off the ground, McGuinness. McKenna coming the other way. So McDermott, McGuinness, McKenna. All in the action. Back it comes to McKenna. In trouble on the outer side. Taken high by Jarman. Nothing doing. Little tip pass out wide as they come again. Rose kick. Eluded Krug. Worsfold. Call it right angles. Out of bounds on the bounce at right half back. Amazing kick that one.
This wind was very, very fluky. Just looking at the flags on top of the stand. Not as strong as what it was earlier.
5:25 remaining in the third period then. Krug has got it. He's battled his heart out. This is Jarman. Jarman gets it inside. Rowe tried to go back to support. They've lost it. Well done. Waterman got it down to Waters. On the break, he goes towards the outer side. Barrage. Barrage on the wing towards half forward. Intended for Wilson. Waiting behind Langdon. The man who kicked the last goal. Carl Langdon wasting no time. High floating kick down towards Heady. Tasker held by the arm. Must get the free kick. Plays on to Lee.
Lee's got nowhere to go.
Still he goes, eventually gets it to Wiedemann, Langdon napped him, in goes Kemp, down goes Hart, no love lost between that pair, here's Lamb over the top, Langdon open goal. A defiant Carl Langdon, and there's 4 points in it, and they've steadied like a top of the table team, no question.
And the breeze, well, is not really a factor at the moment, the windsock a little limp. Quickly across, Lamb, they had options, they just had to draw a man, and Langdon ran onto it. Caught one earlier from Wiedemann, a backhander, but he looks to be all right.
And they've got those two goals to Carl Langdon since Sumich left the ground, interestingly. 7-10 to 7-6, 4.5 minutes left, so not a good 5 minutes by the Adelaide Crows. Lamb gets taken high while he's on the ground. Hocking's just come onto the ground, onto Wren.
for half forward. Jamison.
Oh, well done.
Slips the ball out. Snapshot. He's off target by Hodges.
Gee, that was strong work by Jarman. He put himself in. He was looking for a lead from a bigger fellow. Further down the ground, decided he had to go himself. Used his body well and then hit it out well to Hodges.
5 points the difference. And you would venture to suggest that that wouldn't be enough. The Eagles having the wind in the last quarter. Hodges in front, nearly takes the mark. Klug. Look for the hand pass, big Wren, wisely leaves it for McDermott, the skipper.
Oh.
Onto his left foot, great kick!
Oh!
Three goals to McDermott, the skipper does it again. And once again, the Crows get some breathing space. 3 3/4 minutes left in this quarter.
Well, there have been three sensational goals for McDermott. This one coming on the left foot, Klug looking for Wren, and how he got away, here he is. Now he takes the one step. Bang! What a goal. Held through by Micken. A jubilant Mark Micken.
17 kicks.
What a captain's quarter. Very much the man leading this charge by Adelaide. Vilke. High kick down towards half forward. Worsfold knocks it forward. In goes Pike. Hocking swoops. Keeps it in front. Waters, cannons into him, Jarman stands in the tackle, gets it across to Hodges, now Micken, Micken to Klug, easy as you like, another one. Well, that's terrific. Adelaide 9-11, and the Eagles are 7-6.
Well, they've hit back with two quick goals. I thought they were going to muck it up that time, the Crows, the way they brought it down. They had a 3-on-2 situation. They're hocking here on the burst. Lucky not to get a free kick. Jarman again. Look quick with that. His hands. Hodges. Here it is. Over the top. And then Klug just about to get run down. They fix it.
Some good work there too in that passage of play by Hocking. And so a fine move by Graham Corns to bring him back on close to the end of this quarter. Can the Crows get another one? Knocked down by Wren. Will they get it out of the centre? That's the important thing. Blocked. Good tackle by Bennett. Still the ball there to be won.
They're really overcoming their lack of leg speed, the Crows, by some excellent quick handball.
Jakovic with a very determined look in the background there as we await this bounce. Under 3 minutes left in the quarter. A very crowded bounce it is too. Wren up high, taps down. McDermott not this time, the hand pass was partially smothered. Back it comes to Pike, who's played a very good game this afternoon.
Oh, it's a
Tasker
kick.
Over the top, may have infringed. Was there a whistle? Didn't hear one.
You'd be lucky.
Yes. Quite an obvious one. Under 3 minutes to go.
Not to hear a whistle out there at the present time. Wilson. He's at right half forward. Just over 2 minutes remaining till three-quarter time. 9-11, 7-6, centering kick. Matera, lunging mark.
Well, there was a lot of space in which he could lead then. It was a good kick by Wilson. Matera is endowed with a lot of leg speed.
That was interesting. Tasker ran across the mark, but he's given 5 metres grace when he tracks his man.
Bad marking.
Jakovic.
That's Wren's man.
So Jakovic is about 35 metres from goal. What Henny was trying to do while Matera had the ball was drag his man across the mark and get a 50 for his teammate, but Tasker was inside the five as he tracked him through. Seen an Adelaide player run in front of Matera. That was okay. So here's Jakovic. Important kick this one for both teams.
No, it's one off.
Just missed. It was a good effort into that breeze. But a minor score, 7-7 to 9-11. Wren Jakovic, who started on the bench today. Would have been thrilled with his brother's performance yesterday if he was watching. Tasker comes right down the middle. Here he is again, Jakovic. Goes to ground that time. McIntosh to Langdon to Pike on the 50. Down towards full forward. It goes through for a goal. Oh, that's a sapper, isn't it?
And Don Pike's first. And just looking at the windsock again. The wind has dropped here at Football Park. And the here we go again, these birds, I'm getting confused. The Eagles I really haven't got the disadvantage of wind. You see there, that was a good kick from Pike, kept low.
and that's just what the Crows didn't want. Only 10 points in it again now. Djakovic and Wren. Well, plenty of birds around, Don. There's McDermott. What a great quarter he's played. Lockyer, Waters to the outer side. Wilson. Can the Eagles get another goal? Filkey in pursuit. Knocked down by Maynard.
Good effort, McIntosh.
McIntosh off the bottom. Heady. And the Crows are able to tie it up. And so a bounce will follow. Half a minute to go, but I still fancy their lead isn't big enough.
Langdon now at full forward. Smart picking him up.
And he's kicked two goals there. One as a result of a 50-metre penalty, so he's done well since Sumic actually went off the ground. McGuinness, too much speed for Mainwaring. Kicks to half forward. Jarman was the target. Brennan will do the tidying up work. Clue partially smothers it. Jarman again almost made something out of nothing. Back to McGuinness. Clue, 1 on 50. Clock ticking down. Going goalwards. And he might have gotten that shot at the post. It wasn't to be. So a three-quarter time at Football Park before a sellout house. It's 9-12, 66 the Crows, leading the Eagles 8-7-55.
Three-quarter time, the Crows lead it by 11 points, 9-12 to 8-7, so seven goals in that term. 7-5, kicked by the Adelaide Crows. McDermott, three, all in that quarter. Jamieson has two, and for the West Coast Eagles, Langdon has two.
Today's game is part of the Carlton and United Breweries 1991 AFL Premiership season.
Big Sport on 7 Sport. It's the Ford Australian Open. And ticket sales, as you can see, single session available from August the 1st. Series tickets available from July 31st. You can book on those numbers, just check them out and write down the one of interest to you. And then the World Athletics Championships from Tokyo, August 24 to September 1. Check your local guides for details. And the marathons, of course, of great interest there. We'll have them live for you. Graham Corns at Football Park. His season and theirs very much on the line. A game of lesser importance, I guess, in terms of the Premiership table is being held today at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. If you don't wish to know the score in the clash between Richmond and Fitzroy, look away now. And viewers in Melbourne and Perth will see a replay of that game, Richmond and Fitzroy, immediately after this one at Football Park. Well, three-quarter time, and the Crows working hard in that term, as was the case last week we saw them. They came back strongly after the long break. Will it be enough today? Max Stevens is standing by. What did the coaches have to say, Max?
Well, Graham Corns, Dennis, as you suggested, he knows this is a do-or-die quarter if, in fact, the Adelaide Crows are going to have that mathematical chance of making the finals in 1991. Now, he's told the Crows that they can't afford to give the West Coast forwards an inch. He wants Wiedemann, Smart, Tasker and co. to apply the pressure. His forwards, on the other hand, to create opportunities for the players kicking into the wind. Now, Michael Malthouse, as one would expect, not happy at all, very disappointed, particularly with the West Coast defenders allowing Adelaide a look in. He's after a disciplined final term. Concentration must be lifted along with determination. And Dean Irving, an update, he appears okay and will return if required.
Thanks, Max. What about these numbers, Don?
Well, it's still the use of the handball. It was good handball towards the end of that quarter by Adelaide. They ran the ball with the wind, and they're not upsetting their pattern of play. When they just go back for the long bomb, it's really upsetting their pattern of play, and it was a really good quarter. Again, they're getting the breaks out of the centre. They're a ferocious side when it's in close.
Well, I've got to say, I've seen plenty of state games between Western Australia and South Australia on this ground, but nothing to rival this today. The South Australian fans know the West Australians now so well from so much television exposure. A real edge to this game.
Micken back in the centre.
The start of the final quarter. And the Crows 9-12, the Eagles 8-7, knocked on by Lamb, McGuinness, down towards half forward. The Crows would sell everything, I think, for an early goal. Worsfold has it, left half back, goes towards the wing. In front, Heady, fisted away, Matera waits behind, to the run of Lamb. He goes towards half forward, Pays, favoured by the kick. Andrew Pays, who turns 25 later this month, chips it out wide to number 25. Mark Micken. Micken towards centre wing. It holds up in the breeze. Jakovic did well, changed his mind in flight. Jakovic from the wing. Langdon well off the ground. Not a good kick. Maynard despairing lunge at it. Heady missed it. Backing up Tasker. Philkie confronted. Kept his head well. Kicks towards midfield. Hart is favoured by the ball, needs to go up the ground. Oh, Lamb beat him well. The soccer kick gained about 15 metres. McDermott, who was wonderful in the third corner, showed a lot of the ball to Langdon. Hacked out of mid-air superbly by Lee. Hart to Pays, run down by Matera. They're playing for keeps now. Hart over the ball, and I'm sure the umpire will ball that up.
Simic is back at full forward too. Waterman off for the Eagles.
Hart the last to get up. A bounce right on the edge of the square, and the Crows would give anything for first goal. I dare say the Eagles would too. Kemp onto Lamb, kicks around his body up towards half forward. Micken, oh, the ball props in him well. The former Bears captain. Langdon's tackle was late, but nonetheless a little bit effective. Kemp kicks off the ground. The two blondes combining back to Langdon. Courage needed here, going for this one. That was a pretty heavy collision. Tasker can't get at it, Matera can. Long kick in the goal. That's going pretty close. He's dubbed it, I think. It's 4 points. So Peter Matera kicks his second goal, and a very similar one to his first, also at that end of the ground on.
Well, I like the way Matera uses his speed in a defensive manner. There's a real clash here. Lee, very slow to get up. Also Heady, as Matera goes in one bounce, gets onto that right foot. But he's done exceptionally well, Matera, on that outer wing.
So less than a kick in it. Djakovic and Mikkon, the rucks go at it again. 5 points the margin and a thriller here at Football Park. Hocking looks for the hand pass and gets it. The Crows need the quick reply. And Fulke misses what he should have taken. Moan Wearing puts his body in. Life and limit stake here. Lee, a hurried hand pass, and it's taken away by Thompson.
It will come back. It'll be a Crows free kick at halfback. Adelaide 9-12, West Coast 9-7. Scott Lee just up from centre halfback. A slight lull, not too many of those today. He goes in short, Mikkon. Pay is sold into trouble. Good tackle, Langdon, back to Mikkon. He kicks towards half forward. Main Wearing coming back with a flight of the ball. Hulke did well, knocked it on, taken by Smart. But looking for Jarman, always does something constructive, and again in evidence there to Pays. McDermott, unkind bounce, he goes after it again, well done. Back comes Brennan, tries to shrug the tackle, strong stuff, kicks it towards the outer side. Tregenza's in front, knocked on by Matera. In goes Maynard, he's slung. Waters approaches the ball, missed it. Tregenza has a chance, quick hands, gets it up to Hocking. He was tripped by Waters and will get the free. Pulsating stuff.
He's got to go back behind his mark. Professional free kick. Well done, Waters, because Hocking was on the way. Interesting to see Smart down on the forward line.
Eddie Hocking does this so often. Runs around Waters. Good looking kick. It's a goal.
Well,
Adelaide get their 10th.
Well, his first goal, and what a way to bring it up. The dummy he was going left, oh, he's done this before, and backed himself in with great speed. There he is. Gets that extra few metres, but he's on the run, and a little bit more force behind the ball as he delivers it. Well done, Eddie Hocking.
Well, Eddie Hocking gets his first goal, and these Crows, they won't lie down. McDermott, who had a brilliant third quarter, kicks to half forward, the ball into space, there's no one there. And Pike, long clearing kick.
Oh,
Nick and great mark, just about BOG today, bleeding from the nose. And he's done a fantastic job, gives it away to Pays. Quick kick comes out of the pack to Langdon. Not the most popular player here this afternoon, Carl Langdon, but he wears that. Boundary throw it next to the interchange area, which at Football Park, right on the centre wing. Mikkon and Langdon, they lock arms. They've locked horns today a few times. Kemp's hurried hand pass is to the advantage of Main Wearing. Pays take a high. No free kick. A play on call from the umpire. Langdon pitches it. Oh, good smother, Fulke. Will he get clear? They'll try to get under the left foot. Couldn't do so. Back it comes to Pays. Pays on left centre wing. Goes for distance. The target time and break down. Mark behind the Waterman. Got me a free. He plays on now. Crows.
Sets it. Red.
That's a great mark for the big fellow.
Oh.
Crows sensing maybe a sniff of victory here. They've really lifted. And can the rookie put through the goal? Biblical shot into the wind. That's where the mark is, says the umpire. Here it is in replay.
Look at this from the big fellow. That is a great mark. He will be a player of the future. He's got a bit of lift in his legs, a little bit of speed. And he really does try hard. Just got to put a bit of muscle on that long frame.
Will kick number four be his first goal? It's coming around. And it's a goal. The Reds first, 11-12 to 9-7.
Well, he kicked one last week in a real pressure situation in the third quarter. Sean Wren, and here he is now. I like the way he got in front of Lockyer, who is a stronger opponent, bigger body, but he just got in front. That shows the speed that he has got. If he can work on his game, he'll be a real player, that fellow.
So the margin now, 17 points, Adelaide's way. Terrific start to the final term by the Crows. Lamb in trouble. Ball up. Well, I bet he didn't think at the start of the season, young Wren, that he'd have a kick like that with so much of Adelaide's future riding on it. This is a handy lead now. Micken comes over the top. Lamb got a hand to it. Klug, he's battled hard. Wilson couldn't control it. Brennan towards half forward. Filkey's in the road. Tregenza couldn't mark it. Matera with pace. Long kick. This could bounce through for a goal. It has. He's kicked his third. What a game. The Eagles are 10-7. Adelaide 11-12.
And the Crows, naturally enough, a top team, just won't be denied. It's a terrific effort. Here's material. Follow it up. He contested initially. Look at this.
He's breaks away.
Right on the edge of the square. What a massive kick.
So Matera's third goal, knocked down by Micken again.
Oh, it's a free
There's
kick.
A whistle.
Free kick against Hart.
It'll go to Lamb. That was a shame too, because the Crows were up and running. Big pack of players. McIntosh in front. He comes out with the ball. Lovely dummy. Sells it well. Effective. The hand pass onto Pike. They can kick a goal here. Turley left foot into goal. Oof. Wrong side of the behind post. Or goal post. Four behind. So Crows supporters breathe a sigh of relief. Tasker to kick the ball back in. Under 18 minutes left in this game. Plenty of time for both teams to really sew it up. Adelaide's future on the line for season 91. Micken, oh, what a game. Best game I have seen him play. Oh, filthy clean bowled. He comes up well.
Jarman was held again.
Free kick he's paid. Oh, now it's play on because Jarman did just that. But he did play the free kick one.
Terrific play, Waterman.
Maybe Jarman didn't hear.
My apologies to Waterman. I mentioned he was off the ground. It's Barrich who's off the ground.
So a bounce of midfield. Jakovic. Pike. Across his body with the right foot to half forward. Langdon on the burst. Can he get clear of his opponent? Pays. He can. The little chip shot to Wilson is brilliant.
And Langdon's hurt himself too. He's cramped. The Bronx cheers from the crowd.
And Irving prepares to come back on. Wilson will have a shot at goal. Lets the wind do the work. The ball knocked down. Chance for Kemp. Keeps the ball in play. Or has he? No, he has not. It's out of bounds and a boundary throw in 10 metres from the scoring area.
Clock frozen at 16:44.
Up and running, Langdon, as you see on screen. Wilson.
Big climb from behind. Matera. Pays out of defence. Lamb. Lamb 55 metres out. Puts it on the breeze. Smart and Sumich, it's a goal. What a stunned silence at Football Park as the Eagles string two goals together as they did earlier. And they come back again, just 4 points the margin. The Crows lead.
And down in the forward pocket is Langdon. Still getting attention from the trainers, but Smart holding on to Sumich as that goal went through from Lamb. Lamb's kicked his first. An important one.
So less than a kick in it, and the Eagles all of a sudden right back in business. Micken. Kick to space. McKenna does well. He'll go for the boundary line if he can. Hocking and Matera, and Hocking takes it over. So boundary throw in centre wing. The Eagles right back in this match now, and with the breeze, you would probably favour them to win. Hocking takes a few deep breaths. Irving with Micken, and Micken again taps down, tries for Jarman, couldn't find him. The ball scooped out of the pack. Lee in front, runs out of room. Boundary throw in again. So perhaps the Crows have made about 5 metres, but nothing more. It's been a thriller. Adelaide fans again turning out in force. Capacity crowd here today. Some fantastic crowds here at Football Park. Turley off the ground. Heady, he's had a quiet day. Tasker gives the hand pass away to Maynard. Jarman, good tackle by Pike. The ball spills free again, but Jarman, once more, the quickest hands in the business. On to Tasker, quick hand pass. McDermott, on to McGuinness. Up towards full forward. That's as far as it's going. Lockyer in front.
Andrew Lockyer back towards midfield. Good kick to Lamb. Meters in the clear to Waters. Waters through the middle. Oh, clever kick.
Well done, Hataska.
Yes, he got back on Heady. Pays. And now Thompson. Back come the Crows around the outer side wing. Tregenza and Matera. Oh. Clever mark, Tregenza.
What a battle between those two.
It's been a highlight. Tregenza. Little chip pass down towards the wing. Klug outmaneuvered that time by Brennan. Brennan treads the light fantastic. Gets it across to Wilson. Wilson, explosive, runs to 50. Long kick, good kick, goal.
Well, Peter Wilson, his second goal. One came in the second quarter. And Brennan, an excellent effort to kick that ball in. Most players would give up, but he just managed. There it is, kicking the ball in, plays on. Wilson dodges, and then sets sail, 50 metres, 2-1 he's kicked today.
And this will certainly test the result of the Adelaide Crows. They trail by 2 points into the wind. Can they find something? This is what men are made of. Micken taps down again. Well, they're going to get it once more out of the centre, though. That was Irving. The bouncing ball across the boundary line in front of Pays. And it will be thrown in 50 metres from the Eagles' goal. Rucks go at it. Micken. Maynard. Oh, Thompson couldn't take it. Sumich in front. Ball scooped out to Lee. A high kick will just get the centre wing. Hodges in front. Klug at the back. Gives the hand pass. McGuinness couldn't take it. Irving on the ground. Over to Brennan. Brennan from short of right half forward flank. Spiral punt kick into Langdon. Has the ball fisted away. Smart. That's out of trouble. Lovely sidestep. Trimestier would have been proud. Big pack of players. Irving at the back claims the mark. Taken by Hodges. No mark there, certainly.
Yes.
Oh, the ball.
Yes, I agree with that one. There wasn't a real effort then, mate.
Pulling to take the free kick. Well, suddenly they pick one out, Don. Langdon, good effort to mark. Comes up with the hand pass. Kemp. McIntosh. Kemp again. High kick won't be a score. It will go into the pocket and just about out of bounds. So it's a mark or free kick, whatever, to be taken by Mark Micken.
Micken in the back pocket. It's wind power versus willpower. This crowd of close to 50,000 willing the Crows on. Micken out of the pocket. Enormous task confronting their team now. Off the ground by Kemp. And then again, Mainwaring. In there is McDermott. Eventually Tasker emerges with it. McGuinness leaving it behind Lee. Pike on the 50. Micken again. The big man has exposed some problems for the Eagles in the tall man department and run his heart out this afternoon. This is Pays across the ground. And here they go again. Matera and Tregenza. Worth the price of admission. Wilson got it from Matera. In short to Heady. And Heady, the man who hurt them at Subiaco Oval at the start in round five, has a chance to hurt them equally at the end here.
And McDermott's really hurt. He's done his ankle, but he's limping on.
What a game he's played. The stats on him would be very high indeed. Up around the 40, I'd suggest. Meantime, Heady. Remember that start at Subiaco Oval against Adelaide? What can he muster here? Distance won't be a problem. Accuracy.
Just in towards Maynard. Great mark. Maynard on the run. Can score. Chipped it in short. And the mark taken. Could almost be 50. Jamison has kicked two. Oh, golly.
Isn't that excellent play by Maynard? I can't remember a backman, except you've got to go back to way back to David Dench to see a backman actually run the way that Maynard does. It's fantastic. He's kicked seven goals this year from centre half back.
Can the Crows hit the front again? A goal will do that. into the breeze. He's missed. Is that the season? Crowd almost silent. 79 to 81, 2 points in it.
There's the margin, 2 points. Had he kicked that goal, of course, they would have led by three. Still a long way to go, but what about the odds? 3 points against Carlton, three against North Melbourne. Who knows? Lockyer towards midfield, Mainwaring. Great mark at the second attempt.
Lucky not to be 50 by Wren.
Chris Mainwaring then, up from half-back. What an outstanding game it's been. Towards half-forward, strong mark. Wilson.
Bad marking by Lee to let him get away. You can't do that in crucial finishes. You've got to play shoulder to shoulder or between your man and the ball.
So Wilson, no doubt, will unload for a long bomb here. Inside the centre square. It gets a ride on the breeze. They contest about 5 metres out. Did they touch it? No! It has bounced through for a goal. Well, remarkable.
Wren protesting to the field umpire, the boundary umpire. He's not the man to protest to, but he got a finger to it.
Got to tell somebody.
And here it is from inside the square, the long ball.
Nobody touched it.
Wren did. He put his hand up.
So Peter Wilson has 3 goals and just maybe the West Coast Eagles have the match. Free kick is going to be taken by Dwayne Lamb. No, it's not. Big Irving. Good kick distance wise. Sumic in front of Smart. Off the ground, Sumic. He has been watching Alan Jakovic, but the result was different.
Well, what about the free kick to Sumic? Because Smart had his arm wrapped around his midriff.
Tasker to kick in. Sort of almost get the feeling the Crows may have run their race. 79 plays 88. They need 2 goals against the breeze. That may be a tall order, but they've given it everything. At the back is Craig Turley. Gets around Jarman, but only just. The ball's there to be won. Lamb can't do it. It's McDermott, who's only half fit. Up to Tregenza, out to the centre wing position. Jarman, back to Clue. The Eagles are going to come away with it. Big Irving lumbering a little with that knee injury. Lamb over the top, and this man's played brilliant football. Wilson, he's kicked 3 goals. Turley's been damaging as well. They're setting this up. Langdon taps down. They'll get the ball back with a quick hand pass. Almost there rising. Turley, beautiful sidestep, and can kick a goal from there. Goal umpire says, yes, sir.
What a goal.
His 50th game, Craig Turley, his second goal, and coming at a critical time. He opened up the goal face by going to the right. Good play there by Wren, quickly showing up, although he spotted Langdon with a ball. And there's Turley, just getting his kick as Wren tries to come and smother the boot. And the Eagles, they've got their 14th. Turley second.
The attendance today, 45,684. Great crowd, outstanding game, but you get the feeling it's ebbing away from the Crows now. Good defensive mark from the Pike. Kick is taken by Pays, who wants to go. Now he comes back. And I'm sure Michael Malthouse would be as proud as Punch of this Eagles team today, because they really have been challenged by a desperate Crows outfit. They've weathered the storm and they've played some wonderful football. Jarman sold into trouble. McGuinness, Maynard. Some of the goals they've kicked today, the Eagles, quite outstanding. McGuinness, long kick towards half forward, and Brennan content to watch it go across the boundary line. So, if they lose today, their record will be 9-10, and that should be enough to put them out of contention, the Crows. With that loss by Geelong yesterday, it seems the Eagles, with this victory, should finish on top and take the first final to Subiaco Oval. Ball up, down towards left half forward. For the Eagles, that is.
It's who their opponents are going to be. Dennis is quite interesting at the moment, though, isn't it?
Yes, wide open. Still a terrific finish. Lots of chances, certainly for 5 of the 6 spots. Waters threw it out. The umpire was on the blind side of it. Waterman to Mainwaring. Probing kick into the forward line. Smart over the top. Tasker out of mid-air. Goes out towards the boundary line. Wilson, an explosive pace and evidence again there. So quick, this time he can't control it. On that last occasion, the umpire not prepared to guess. I think earlier, he guessed in a similar situation when McGuinness was holding the ball.
Holding the hamstring, the left hamstring, Dennis. Wilson.
Boundary throw in.
Yes, he looked a little bit proppy, but he's played well. This is Thompson. A quick kick up to the centre wing position. Watters and Lamb could have rattled it. Lamb kicks long. And that will roll through for one behind. So 6 minutes left. Time and the Eagles, it would appear, have triumphed. In fact, under 6 minutes, five and a half now. Tasker goes to the outer side. Or Wren, that's what he should have taken. Irving.
He followed up well, didn't he?
Up, holding the ball. Yes, sir, paid it. Good tackle.
It's great to see a big man do things like that. That's why he's got a future, that fellow.
Rent from right half-back flank. Kicks to the centre wing position. Knock away by Brennan. McGuinness goes down. Take it away by Big Irving.
Heady coming
out of bounds. And coming back on will be Barrich. Rent done a good job. Only a rookie. Heady heads to the bench. Players on the other side of the ground at the moment. Sumich is going to do it with Wren. McGuinness, who had it and then fumbles unaccountably. Back to Tregenza. Marking contest on the centre wing position. Hodges got one hand to it. Goes up a lot one-handed. Going to be a Crows ball though. Maynard, as we mentioned, loves to kick a goal. Loves to run. They need one badly. Kicks it in short. Beautiful pass to Hart. Not wasting any time. Kicks into the pocket. That's a fantastic mark. How did he get back there, Maynard? Great footy.
He loves to run, doesn't he? Lining up for his eighth, or he's looking for options, but he can line up here for his eighth goal for the year.
Well, if he kicks it, they'll be back in business. Tried to bend it through. Not successful. John Klug will see the ball go out of bounds in front of him. And with it, maybe the Crows' last hopes today as we tick down to under 4 minutes.
The margin, 16 points. How's that for a centre-half forward? 29 possessions, John Klug. Back after suspension. Nick and Held. He'll kick from about 45, but even this will test him.
Wilson's going to come off too, Dennis. He's favouring that left leg, whether it's the hamstring or the quad. We'll have to just wait and see, but Heady coming back on.
Wonderful game by Wilson. There when it counted. Micken. Breeze grabbed that. Mark is missed by Waterman. Hart dragged down by Waterman. And I think that expression says it all. They've had plenty of Hart today, but they won't get the 4 points. Brennan over the top. Out of bounds. Right full forward.
So boundary throw in with 3 minutes to play. Scoreboard showing 79-95, so they need 3 goals, and that's almost an impossible task at this stage of proceedings. McDermott, quick kick was smothered. Jamison, ball paddled out, past the 50-metre line now. Going through solidly was Kemp, onto Lamb. The Eagles come again, but that's about as far as they're going. Tregenza pops it up high. Hodges takes a good mark, maybe too far out to score. And realises that gone. Tries to play on Wren. Here's the hand pass away. McDermott off target. One behind. So crowd will go home thinking perhaps of next year, because it would be just about mathematically impossible to make the finals now. Clock stopped as Lockyer prepares to kick in. McKenna is the target, and McKenna doesn't let him down.
Clever mark that one.
Played well today, McKenna.
Yes, very well. Main Waring drops the mark. Now he's in trouble. Over the neck. With shoulder, says the umpire. Main Waring through centre. Maynard interfered with by McIntosh. Will get the free kick. 14-11 to 11-14. Jarman tried very hard. a real classy customer towards half forward. Hodges reduced to spoiling that time. Irving runs across the line. Throw it in, says umpire Vernon. Down to 1:30 remaining in the game. Klug and Irving. Over the top, Brennan. McGuinness. Pike, who's been always close to McGuinness. Tackled strongly by Hodges.
He's worked hard, Hodges. Across half forward. He's tackling. He's been of a high standard.
So bounce at left half forward. Irving. Waters couldn't control it. And another bounce.
As the clock ticks down under 1 minute now. I think if you look back over the scorecard, if the Crows are to lose this match, and that would appear a certainty now, when they kick 1-7 with the wind from the first quarter, Waters, taken high by Hodges, will get the free kick. It was interesting too that Worsfold, Don, elected to kick against the breeze, so tactically that move has come off. Scott, yes. Waters.
Well, the breeze really was a factor early, Peter. A strong...
Didn't pay it to Wren. Jarman, as I said, the quickest hands in the business. Tasker from left centre wing. 2-on-1 in favour of the Eagles, and a good mark taken by Worsfold. That was a masterly stroke, kicking against the breeze. The defence held up in the first quarter and restricted the Crows to 1-7. Scott Waters. As we tick down to the siren, it's possession football now. Well, good tackle applied by Jamison, and the ball spills free. But there's the siren, the Eagles have run out winners. A top game of football here at Football Park. The final score showing the league leaders victorious by 15 points. 14-11, 95 to the Adelaide Crows, 11-14, 80. But I thoroughly enjoyed the game, Don. But I think, as I said before, but when the Crows look back on that scoreboard, 1-7, In the first quarter, kicked by Adelaide as against the Eagles 1-1, it wasn't good enough. Let's go down to Max Stevens.
Peter Matera, congratulations. Great effort by you personally and the team.
Yeah, it was a very good effort. It's hard to beat Adelaide, like everyone's been losing on this ground, but it was good to win, and just got to wait till next week now.
How difficult was the wind here today? It was gusting up to about 25 k's.
Yeah, well, we went for the against it so we can hold it up so they can't score. So we did our best, and it came out there, so it's good.
How hard is it to play in Adelaide? You play in Victoria every second week, but here at Adelaide, I mean, the crowd of 46,000.
Yeah, no, it's a very good crowd. It's going to be like the final, so we've got to get used to it. But it was a real good crowd, and Adelaide were good, but we come off best, so it's good.
Your own performance?
I'm pretty happy. It's good.
I'm sure you would be. Thanks very much to Peter Matera.
Well, Peter Matera, he should be pretty happy. He finished up with 3 goals. And Crow supporters applauding their team off the ground. And why shouldn't they? Because they really did put in a top performance. Wilson got 3 goals and Langdon 2, the major contributors for the West Coast Eagles. And McDermott finished up with 3. Top game of football from him, and Jamison 2. So, as I said, mathematically now it's almost impossible for Adelaide to make the top 6. But the West Coast Eagles, Don, how did you rate their performance?
Well, I thought it was an excellent performance. Actually, the whole game was of such a high standard. The wind was the only problem, but really, congratulations to both sides.
Okay, from Football Park, we'll take a break. The final score, 82-95 in favour of West Coast. Back in just a moment. And welcome back to Football Park. Checking that final score, 14-11-95. The West Coast and Adelaide, 11-14-80. The two goals in the first half under pretty difficult conditions, as Peter Matera just mentioned, Don, wasn't really good enough.
No, it wasn't, Peter, but as I mentioned earlier, it was a terrific game. I like the way that they adapted to the wind. Both sides were going very long with long bombs, hoping the forwards would mark. But I like the way they adapted the Adelaide side initially in the third quarter. They started to run the ball with the wind, you know, not getting out of their pattern of play. Their pattern of play, because they lack leg speed, is to hand ball quickly as soon as they get it and try and get out and out, and where they've got a little bit of time to deliver the ball to someone in a better position further down the ground. They haven't got the real leg speed of the West Coast, but the West Coast are a polished unit. And also you can look at the bodies of those West Coast fellows in comparison to Adelaide. And in a couple of years, when the Adelaide side do build themselves up to the standard of AFL football, they will be a real force. And it won't be in the not too distant future, because what they've got going for them is a ton of heart. They put themselves in, and all of their players, just about all of their players, run hard at the ball, aggressively at the ball, and they run in a straight line. McDermott was fantastic in that third quarter, kicking goals, but the way he threw himself in, he carried injuries. And this is Turley, this is an excellent goal in that last quarter. He was a good player, and they had a lot of good players today.
Final quarter,
finally the Eagles home 14-11 to 11-14, the margin 15 points. So many good players for both sides out there this afternoon. Max Stevens is standing by. Max, who have you got for us?
Michael Malthouse, Dennis, and Michael, you've got a few tired players in there, but you got away with the points, pretty good win.
Well, it was a good win in the end, but full credit goes to the Crows. They're undermanned. I don't think there's many sides in the competition that have lost five players from the previous week through injury and still give a terrific account of themselves here. I mean, they were a desperate side looking for a place in the top six, and we were desperate to stay on top. So, all in all, it was one of those real tight games. The wind, of course, meant it was a sort of a one half of the ground game, and they bottled us up and played very well. We got the 4 points, that's what we come for.
And the crowd factor, I mean, that must be a good test going into the finals.
Yeah, the crowd, they're probably learning to be a bit like Victoria Park and Windy Hill and Moorabbin. But that was a good test for a couple of younger players to experience 45 plus there.
Okay, Michael, thanks very much, and all the best for the finals.
Okie doke, thanks very much.
Thanks, Max. Pride was very much on the line at the Melbourne Cricket Ground this afternoon. Richmond against Fitzroy. If you don't wish to know the score, we've got a replay coming up in most states. For the rest of Australia, though, here's the score. Look away if you don't wish to know. So there you've got it. Now, round 21, and look at the top two. A couple of outstanding games at the WACA ground come Friday night, a clash of the top two teams. That lost to Carlton, a big one yesterday for Geelong. West Coast and Geelong then Friday night. And then the old rivals go at it at the Melbourne Cricket Ground on Saturday. Melbourne and Collingwood, St Kilda play Carlton, Footscray and Adelaide, Essendon and Brisbane, Hawthorn, Fitzroy, and Sydney and North Melbourne, a danger game there for...